Wings open their season with a little magic. Jake Berge and Tom Marichek up to their old tricks, that of the hat variety, and a young rookie teaching the league some new tricks.
Has a man alone in front, score! Jason Clark's a game winner!
Tonight, the Wings will try to win number two against Rochester. On a crisp winter's eve in Philadelphia, the Wings with a formidable opponent tonight. The high-scoring Rochester Knighthawks have come to town to take on the Philadelphia Wings, and it's coming up next. Oh, hi again, everybody. With Scott Gabrielson, I'm Larry Rosen. Welcome to our coverage of the Philadelphia Wings. Rochester 2-0 with a vaunted offensive attack. So, Scotty, the first focus becomes Dallas Elliott, the back line for the Philadelphia Wings.
Yes, Dallas Elliott, as they say, the Wings go as Dallas Elliott goes, the best goalie in the league. He is a very acrobatic goalie. He holds his ground. He baits goalies. He baits the shooters and makes the save. He makes saves from inside and outside on top of him. For the Wings to have a big game, they need a big game out of Dallas Elliott.
Dallas Elliott approaching a wonderful milestone, 3,000 career saves in 10 seasons, an eight-time member of the All-Pro team. One of the major focuses in the offseason this year for Philadelphia was to get bigger, to get stronger, to not take the pounding. One member of the team is making his debut tonight who's going to add some size. His name's Andy Towers, joining the Twin Towers with Peter Jacobs.
Absolutely. We needed some big men, and there they are, Peter Jacobs and Andy Towers, 6'5 and 6'4 respectively. Andy Towers, as you said, number 44, making his debut. Look for big defense out of Andy Towers tonight.
And Peter Jacobs, 6 assists in the first two games, standing by with their own Leif Elsmo. Gentlemen.
Well, fellas, Peter Jacobs certainly has the size right here, All-American out of Hopkins, playing for this Wings team as a faceoff guy. Defensive specialist, but you can really score big goals. Peter, I've watched you, had a great career. Tonight, your team goes for some size differential. Towers, Stilley, and you come in here with great size. What's the objective?
Just to try and slow them up. They're a very quick and very talented team. They can run with the best of them. But we feel if we just stay face-to-face with them and don't let them get their head of steam with their size, we might be able to slow them down a little bit that way.
Okay, they've got some special talent like Grant and Casey Powell. Not only are they exceptional shooters, but they have moves that are very, very hard to read and defense. What do you do with guys like that?
Again, we try and stay up in their face. We don't let them make the move. We try and dictate to them instead of let them dictate to us.
How about transition? That would kill you with Rochester.
Yes, we got to cut down their transition, try and create transition for ourselves. They are great team speed, and we're just going to try and cut it down as best we can, cut the field in half.
All right, Peter Jacobs, very tough obstacle for them defensively. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, thank you, Leif. For Rochester, you mentioned those couple of very special players. They're the last two number one draft choices, young, talented, and fun to watch.
Two of the most exciting players in the game today, John Grant Jr. and Casey Powell. Very outstanding offensive threats. These guys have to be watched by the Wings. John Grant Jr. has a magical stick. Look for big, huge fakes out of him and strong shots from outside. Casey Powell, deadly to the left, deadly to the right. He's slippery, he's quick. Watch out for Casey Powell.
And if the name John Grant sounds familiar, yes, indeed, he's the son of the all-time member of the Philadelphia Wings from the early days, John Grant Sr. Stay tuned, everybody. Scott and I will come back with a special ceremony, and we'll start our contest off for you in just a moment.
Roger, squad leader, we've got them covered. Lock on target and fire at will.
Tickets for the Philadelphia Wings' next home game are on sale now. The Wings take on their arch rivals from Long Island, the New York Saints. This Saturday night, 7:30 at the First Union Center. Tickets to all 2000 season home games are on sale at Ticketmaster or call 215-336-2000. Join the team. Get your tickets now. Because they're coming in hot.
I am sick and tired of hearing that our league is inferior to the NHL.
Yeah!
It is time for us to show the world what they are missing.
Yeah!
Let us take our product to the people.
Yeah!
To do this, we must first name a commissioner, someone who is savvy, connected, someone with a past. All those in favor, raise your hand. Where is Murph?
What?
Oh, why do I bother? Look at you!
An important component to shooting is developing quickness. Quickness is developed through hand positioning. You want to make sure you drive your hands forward in front of your body. You want to get the bottom hand up so you can pull And you want to keep the top hand down so you can maximize the push and pull and develop quickness. That'll really help increase your percentage on shooting.
Wings Lacrosse is brought to you by Pico Energy, no doubt about it. By Pepsi, proud to be the official sponsor of the Philadelphia Wings. By Snyder's of Hanover, America's favorite pretzel bakery. By Penn Orthopedics, more doctors, more experience, more choices. By First Union, your guide to the financial world. And by Warrior, the means to dominate. Once again, live from the First Union Center here in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, for National Lacrosse League action, the Philadelphia Wings, Rochester Knighthawks. Moments ago, Kevin Finneran became the owner of the longest consecutive games played streak in the history of indoor lacrosse with 98, third on the all-time list of goal scorers. There he was honored by Russ Klein, Michael French, Steve Govett, the general manager, and the former holder of that record. My color commentator Scott Gabrielson there, the numbers on Philadelphia's Iron Man. The number two man on that list, all-time games played, Dallas Elliott. And his save percentage a little low by his normal standards at 761, 1-1 through two games. In goal, Pat O'Toole has been outstanding in the early going. Save percentage of 81.8. A 2-0 record, very active goalkeeper, Pat O'Toole, 2-0 for these undefeated Knighthawks of Rochester. Mike Ventura, Tom Young, Brian Abbott have their protocol on the field tonight. Great crowd on hand. It's Philadelphia Wings indoor lacrosse against the Rochester Knighthawks. Philadelphia in their home black, trimmed in the white, silver, and red. Rochester in that baby blue and white will operate to our right. We are just about set for action. Peter Jacobs, Andy Towers, welcome back to the National Lacrosse League. Number 44, Andy Towers, hasn't played professionally indoor in 5 years, took that faceoff and wound up on his back. And I'm sure that helps him a lot more than it hurts him, helps him kind of get going, get into the game a little bit, as he has the defensive presence in front of Dallas Elliott. And Dallas has an easy one to start, but a foul's called off the ball on young Mike Buzza, number 41 for Philadelphia, so possession and a fresh clock coming for Rochester. Rochester led by John Grant. He wears number 24. Chasing it back down to the veteran Corey Bombury, wearing 72. They spread the field with no action in front. Look for some cutters. Jacobs on the pass, and that was behind his mark. Randy Mears, and Philadelphia will change on the go. The offensive unit comes out the right side door. Jake Berge sends it across. Shot on the bounce from Sean Radebaugh. That goes long. Shot clock does not reset as we welcome Scott Gamers, and that is a new personal floor record for floor to balcony.
I'm a little out of breath, so keep the huffing and puffing down.
Oh, you got here in under a minute.
All right. Well, it's great for Kevin Finner to break that record. He's joined the Iron Man Club. It's a good company to be in.
There's that last offensive thrust inside and the shot over the top from Jason Clark, the rookie who had such a magnificent night on opening night. Rochester, good.
They're going to expect a lot of things out of Jason Clark already this year. He's had a game winner. He was a little silent against Pittsburgh last week, and now this week he needs to pick it up again.
Shot, the save just to beat the shot clock. Shot from top of the slot by Jeremy Hollenbeck, and Dallas stood his ground. Again, Philadelphia changed on the go. Berge holds it out high with a look in front, and the save is made, and the rebound is good.
Outstanding. That's the way it starts it off. Dallas Elliott makes the first save. The Wings push it up the floor. Jake Berge goes untouched, takes a shot. It's the second chance effort that the Wings need to capitalize on, and they do here. Nobody picks up Berge. Big save by the goalie, but Tom Fair's right there, bats it in. First goal of the game. Here's Berge coming down, takes a shot. Fair comes in, little bat at the end. There you go, there's your goal. Well done, Tom Fair.
Well, he got it off the side of the stick, but had some authority to it. Tommy.
He knew where to put it.
Fourth year performer, 1-0 Philadelphia.
One thing we touched on earlier, Larry, is the actual lineup that the Wings are working with. They've got a bigger squad in here. It should be interesting to see how everybody plays together.
And let's check with Leif Elsmo on our Warrior keys to the game.
Well, Larry and Scott, the Warrior keys to the game are simply that this team from Rochester can score in transition. The Wings have to stop the transition goals. Great stick work from Rochester. And then is Big better? The bigger size of the Wings has to have an impact. So far, it's looked pretty good. And then Elliott, he's been so sensational over the years. He's really helped them get that 1-on-1 record. He has to be on top of his game tonight. So far, he looks great.
Handle that through the screen. Thank you, Leif. And we've got a whistle, and Ryan is mixing it up. Tom Ryan for Philadelphia with the assistant captain, Tim Soudan, veteran performer.
Tim Soudan, there's a veteran for you. He is a very difficult player to cover. He's got a great dodge down the left-hand side of the goal. He is normally a very hard offensive player to cover. Tom Ryan is looking to give him a little bit of business, try to take him out of his game. That's the way you have to cover Soudan.
They started on the right side. Working through, the shot is well wide from John Grant. Loose ball, Ryan committed up the floor and was unable to get back to it, so Soudan does. In front, nice pass, look, shot, Dallas there. Right on the doorstep with Kurt Malowski.
He's starting off on the right foot. That is Dallas Elliott. He's making the big saves for the Philadelphia Wings. It only helps the Wings on their offensive end.
Clark with the pass. Ooh, body goes flying. Two bodies go flying, all courtesy of Jamie Hanford.
When you talk about bigger is better, Jamie Hanford's one of those guys that's bigger and he's pushing some bodies around.
At 6'2", 215, another one. Solid shot there from Stilley. Dave Stilley making his first appearance on the home floor this year at 6'2", 215. Hear a lot of that 6'2", 215.
One of the things that the Wings needed to go after was size on defense, and Leif touched on it with Peter Jacobs. You've got Dave Stilley, who's a defensive player, number 77. Jamie Hanford, number 88. Andy Towers, number 44.
Score! And just snuck through from Tom Slate. And in the first 4 minutes, you've got goals from Tom Slate and Tom Fair. That is a good sign.
Tommy Slate, big left-hander. Nobody comes, picks him up, takes a shot from outside, shoots it low, sneaks through the five hole of the goaltender. Goal number two for the Wings. Tom Slate was a scratch last week. This is his first game back, and it starts off the game right. Number 43 has his first goal of the season.
2-0 Philadelphia. You talked about scoring balance in our opening night. Yeah, you got to get some stuff from your big guys. But you get those second, third, fourth line kind of contributions, man, you can really look very, very strong.
Absolutely. One of the things that's so different for the Philadelphia Wings this year is the well-roundedness of the team. Historically, the Wings have had 13 to 15 guys that they stayed with every game, game in, game out. This year, the Wings have enough balance on the team that there's going to be strategic changes. There's going to be personnel changes. Guys are sitting that aren't used to it, but every person on that roster is a threat, and you're seeing two goals out of two guys today that normally don't score goals.
And again, against Rochester, you're gone with size, you're gone with strength, and you're not going to get beat up on your home floor. In front, hugging the near post, and keeping that away was O'Toole on the shot from Maracek. Tommy ranges behind, bounces off the boards, tries the 360, holds his ground and gets his shot off. My goodness.
He's just back in there. Great stick work for Tom Maracek. He gets the isolation. He wants to take him to the goal. Pushes inside, tries to take the inside roll. Tommy's got a fantastic stick, knows where he is in the crease, almost dunks it over O'Toole's shoulder.
With 161 goals as a member of the Philadelphia Wings, the all-time leader. And you talk about work rate. He's always working. The shot is handled low by Pat O'Toole. Tried to play it back to O'Toole, but it pops off the net and right back at you.
We haven't talked much about the Rochester Knighthawks yet, but they've got one of the most balanced scoring teams in the league right now. They've got players that can, each person on their roster can score a goal. Last game, each man had at least a point for the team. So any guy on the floor can hurt you besides John Grant Jr. and Casey Powell.
Philadelphia really taking the body in the first 6 minutes. And Dallas keeping the porch clean as well. That's played through. Dallas can't get a piece of it. Again, banging away out of the top. Play goes on as Berge is working over Grant really strongly, top of the slot. Off the ball. Get to know me.
It's one of the matchups that we wanted to see. John Grant Jr. against Jake Berge and some of the bigger Philadelphia Wing defenders. Great defense by the Wings there. They hold the Knighthawks to 30-second turnover.
Look at who is not in lineup for tonight for Philadelphia. Sanderson, we won't see, a backup goalkeeper. Gawa Schindler, Rogers also not playing, the captain. Trainer, these are healthy scratches by and large, as Scotty told you, trying to build some competitive spirit for playing time and mix and match for the opponent.
Absolutely. We want to see everybody, see how everybody can play together, see what kind of effort everybody can put in. And it's a very well-rounded team, and good players are going to sit on the bench while their guys get their opportunities.
Finner in the outlet to McAvoy. McAvoy the cross for the cutting Ryan Luke. Can't hold on off the stick. And it's picked up on the ground by Brad MacArthur.
One of the things that I've been very curious to see this year is John Grant Jr. playing in the indoor league. The Rochester Knighthawks have a veteran team with Dwayne Jacobs, Tim Sudan, and a lot of the Knighthawks players. Is John Grant trying to come over and take over the Rochester offensive power play?
McAvoy. Good dodge. McAvoy behind. Oh, he set that up so brilliantly, but was up unable to find Jason Clark in the perfect position. Jason needed a step to get a shooting angle. Oglesby brings it back out high. Buzzing as again a body goes down in front. Stilley, shot clock violation.
And they turn it over. It was good defense by Rochester.
It is 2-0 early on Philadelphia at the halfway mark of period number one. It's not too late to become a Wings season ticket holder. 3 and 4 game packages still available. Call 215-389-WINGS. Operators are currently standing by. Back to the first.
Board meeting.
Tilly. No. Tilly.
You can never be too prepared. That's why Pico Energy uses advanced technology to find problems before they happen. Isn't it nice when someone looks out for you? Pico Energy, no doubt about it.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Serious. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. Warburg.com.
You can bring the whole family to the next Wings home game. Get 4 tickets, 4 hot dogs, 4 sodas for just $66. For more on the family pack value, call 215-389-WINGS. We're here for the Bear Creek Mountain. Coach has to be happy. Philadelphia, an early 2-0 lead for Tony Resch, and they're doing it the style that he's hoping for.
We highlighted the defensive intensity of Philadelphia Wings. Here's Dave Stille giving some of that intensity right there on the defensive end. And then Tom Slate coming in with a big shot from outside for his first goal of the season.
And we come back to live action at the 7:23 mark with Rochester walking it up, and they know they are in a contest. Rochester has been dynamic in first periods, 11-6. In fact, 23-11, there's their first one. And that's right off the stick of the young master, John Grant Jr.
It's probably not the last time you're gonna hear Powell to Grant. Casey Powell takes the ball down the floor. Good defense by Silly, pops it over to Grant, who's got a fantastic shot. Big left hand, drops his stick, hits the ground and puts it past Dallas. Here's another angle from it. Just a great shot. Got a little skip on it and beat Dallas to the back of the net.
Grant had 4 goals and 5 assists last time out. A 9-point performance in the win against Pittsburgh.
John Grant was the NCAA Player of the Year last year out of the University of Delaware. He's a very strong kid. He may not be the fastest or athletic player on the field, but he's got an incredible stick. He's got great size. He'll back in and he'll beat you with a big fake or a big shot from outside. He's a guy that the Philadelphia Wings went very hard after in the offseason to try to get him in a uniform that his father wore. He does have a legacy with the Philadelphia Wings, but unable to achieve that trade.
Averaged over 6.5 points per game as a Division I collegiate lacrosse player. Not a bad number. It's 2-1. Rochester on the attack. Ball's broken free. Well done by Hanford. Has some open floor down the left wing. Has Oglesby screening. Nice screen shot. Left elbow save by Pat O'Toole. Oglesby alone in the slot. Has it. Stop. Pop. Oh, that's off a couple of pipes. Thought that was counted. Great shift.
The Wings are playing a different brand of ball tonight. They're hustling all over the floor. They're getting the second shots. They're getting the second efforts. They're beating Rochester to the ground ball. Matt Oglesby, here's his shot. Fakes, goes off the pipe. Great shot by Matt Oglesby. Takes the fake, gets the shot. Unfortunately, hits the iron. One of the things that the Wings want to do is set the tone in this game, and I think that's what they're doing, Larry. It's always a goal for the Wings to come out strong, come out physical, try to get some points before the other team can get its feet underneath itself. That's what they've done.
That's trainer Mike Cerami, who is out with the veteran Corey Bombry, who seems to have had the wind and perhaps a little bit more knocked out of him as he gingerly heads toward the Knighthawk bench.
This may give me an opportunity to talk a little bit about what the Wings did in the offseason. They've made some strategic moves up in the front office as well as on the field. Mike French is the executive vice president of the team, as well as was the former GM. They brought in Steve Govett, a former player, is now the full-time GM of the Wings. What they want to do in the offseason was make the trades, make the acquisitions of guys that can help the team. We talked about the size, bringing in Andy Towers, Tom Fair, Jason Clark, Gaywa Schindler. These guys are all going to help the Philadelphia Wings this year, and that's due to the fact of a different philosophy by the brand trust, so to speak, of the Philadelphia Wings.
Philadelphia will come out of that with a man advantage, playing 5-on-4. The penalty was off the ball. Sudan is in the box. Shot handled, covered on the rebound. Pat O'Toole does a nice job handling rebounds and a fine outlet pass. Has Casey Zapp, who stops and brings it back out. Wise decision, they'll change on the go.
Not a great switch by the Philadelphia Wings, getting their power play players off and their defensive players on. There's a little of that stick fake by John Grant Jr. Watch for that tonight. He may lose our cameraman a few times tonight. He's so good at that.
That's Pal Ragging with the high Sox. Shot is low and easy on the scoop for Dallas Elliott. And Matt Oglesby, they'll change on the go. As we're midway through the first man advantage.
One of the keys to the Philadelphia Wings always has to be on a power play to take advantage when they have an extra man. They have a fantastic power play. They have to capitalize and score when they have the extra man.
Knighthawks playing a straight up box, just covering position behind the back. Maracek, the Finneran, whose shot is handled. Rebound, Maracek. fakes, dives inside, takes it behind.
New 30-second clock. They should set it up.
Loose ball, and over and back it goes, so possession belongs to the Knighthawks.
Not a good turnover on the power play. The sticks are a little rusty to start the game out here. Got to tighten them up.
And with 4:40 and counting period one, you see the power play time remaining. Whistle off the ball, timeout called by Rochester in full possession. With 11 seconds left on the man advantage, Paul Day takes a timeout.
They've got their penalty killing unit on the floor. The Philadelphia Wings still have the man advantage, so they're gonna regroup.
And we will as well. Wings with an early 2-1 lead, late in period number one. Scotty and I coming back at you in a moment.
Snyder's of Hanover has been baking pretzels for almost a century. Pretzels crafted from old world recipes and slow baked to perfection. With over 20 varieties, there's a favorite for everyone. Visit the Pretzel Bakery in the Snyder's section of your grocery store today.
Snyder's pretzels are munchably, crunchably, got a hunch they're gonna be
the finest bakery pretzels anywhere.
Snyder's of Hanover, America's pretzel bakery since 1909.
Mad Dogs and Canadians, the indoor game. And the Philadelphia Wings, Powell comes out as they will set for an offensive set. Jacobs goes through the slot with Stilley chasing, ragging, and the penalty has indeed ended. Shot is blocked. Buzzer with the nice block. That sets up the breakaway for the flying Oglesby. Max shot! Saved by the left shoulder. He got himself in pretty close. Buzzer brings it back out. Looking across, shot over the top.
Had a fresh 30-second clock there, Larry. They should have tried to pull it out a little bit and get their offensive players on the floor.
Casey Powell is buried from behind by Buzza, by Fair from in front. And it looks like a delayed penalty coming up on Philadelphia as again a body flies. Jamie Hanford puts his man down.
Looked pretty darn clean to me, Larry. A lot of it physical intensity out of the Wings. They are coming out of the box fired up. They are really putting some muscle on the Rochester Knighthawks. Casey Powell's coming down, he loses control of the body. Great hit by Tom Fair on the slide, and he's gonna get called for the penalty. I guess they're gonna call it high into the chin. Gave him a little bit of the business under the neck. Guess we're putting Tom Fair in the
business.
Penalty box.
In the business, yeah, caught an elbow up, but that's, you know, he starts turning his head because he lost the ball, a free shot. And Tommy really hit him hard. They'll call it for charging, which might be a little bit of an unusual call, but nonetheless, first man advantage opportunity.
I'm repetitive with saying setting the tone, but the Philadelphia Wings set the tone. The next time Casey Powell comes down the chute like that, he's gonna know that a Philadelphia Wings player is coming to knock him down.
That is called a 5-minute major, and Coach Resch cannot believe it. So Philadelphia will be down until early period two. No one in the slot as they work perimeter. Grant backing away, really controls the play off the left arm of Elliott. New shot clock, across the slot. Little tapper in front is picked off. Good job, outlet from McAvoy, looking for Oglesby, can't come out with it. It's 3-on-2 on this end. Good look in front, crossing, shooting, scoring. Well done, little three-way touch play, and Malowski winds up with the goal. His fifth of the young season, we're tied at 2.
Great stick work by the Rochester Knighthawks. Just really nice intensity following the ball. They have a very, very difficult man-up or power play to defend. They move the ball around. Malowski takes a good look at the net and beats Dallas to the upper right-hand corner. Defense is rotating. Malowski gets Dallas, turning his head, sticks to the upper right-hand corner.
Yeah, Malowski is, among the all-time goal-scoring leaders for this Rochester club. 25th of the season, 38th on his career.
5 minute major is going to hurt the Philadelphia Wings. I think that's a little extreme, but the refs are trying to call that stuff this year. So now the Philadelphia has to burn some time before they give it back to the Rochester Knighthawks.
Yeah, still over 4 minutes of man down time for Philadelphia. Berge gives to Finneran. He can double team Kevin, but he still runs his way through it, and a crease violation's called. No, they're going to a little bit of an even up cross check called on Casey Zaff. So it'll only be a 2 minute minor.
I believe it was a penalty off the ball where Zaff took a cross check to the crease man as he was trying to cut through.
So the penalty for Fair of Philadelphia has 3:53 remaining. 2 minute minor called on Zaff. So we're now at four aside. What's the critical element of four aside?
Four aside, this plays into the Philadelphia Wings because they are excellent dodgers from outside. It creates more room on the floor to take shots.
Berge took that one from in tight.
It's got to be a man-to-man situation now. The matchups have to be key. Just as if it is a man advantage for Philly, it's an advantage for Rochester. Now here are the matchups. John Grant, big guy. Taking John McAvoy to the hoop. No switch there. Luckily, Grant missed the shot.
He did work his way in front well. McAvoy double teamed. So he uses the open floor, and Philadelphia will come. Last 2 minutes, period one. Berge, good look in the slot. Shot over the shoulder, score! Brilliant Tommy Maracek, the wraparound.
He's certainly the guy that you want sprinting from the bench. That's a coaching move. Always have Tom Maracek ready to shoot the bench. Get your best offensive players on the floor. Jake Berge pulls it out. Tom Maracek comes streaking. Balls in the wrong side of his stick. Whips it around his shoulder for a bounce shot goal. Unbelievable goal by Tom Maracek.
Now, can that be taught, or is that purely instinctual?
That is so tough to teach. It's a natural instinct. Tom Maracek, when you talk about a magician on the floor, Tom Maracek is one of the originals. He can shoot from anywhere, and that shot right there is not something that everybody on that floor can do. Beautiful goal by Tommy Maracek.
Takes over the team lead now with 7 goals, 10 points, the leading shooter by far on the club.
For most people, you take that when you're offhand, you pull that ball out and just wait for somebody else to take the shot. For Tom Maracek, you never know.
Good defense. Oglesby breaks it free. Philadelphia 2-on-1, 3-on-1 if they hurry. Hanford stopping, lining it up. Takes himself out of position for the shot. Stilley will
bring
it. Smart
play, though. Smart play by Jamie Hanford. These are their defensive players. These are their clock killers. Jacob, Stilley, Hanford coming off, and now the offensive players for the Philadelphia Wings getting on. Clark, Radabaugh, Maracek, Berge. Great four-man game, great two-man game.
Berge scores! Like a wild freight train. Down the slot in the back of the net.
When you take one player off the field and you get a four-on-four set up on the floor, it creates a whole different ball game. It sets up your two-man game. It sets up your pick and roll. This was worked perfectly. Berge comes to a strong side. Maracek sets the pick. Sudan does not make the slide. Berge comes in, fakes out O'Toole, bang, to the upper right-hand corner.
Great feet, though. Really terrific
great
feet.
Great move. Late slide. Great fake by Jake Berge and sticks it in the upper left-hand corner. Great speed and footwork by young Jake Berge.
It's 4-2, Philadelphia. Berge with goal number 7, retakes the points lead with the 11. Zaff comes out, sprints across the bench, so it'll be a 5-on-4 as soon as he gets there. For the final 40 seconds, Jacob shot just wide of the open far corner. And it's 8 rows up in the stands.
Man down defense for the Wings. McAvoy, Jacobs, Slate, and Oglesby. These guys are athletic. They can get around and defend against the rotation of the Knighthawks.
Beautiful over the shoulder pass, but the shot was stopped by Elliott. Final possession as it came up. Dwayne Jacobs, 3-on-1 shot from Peter Jacobs. And with 15 seconds left, 2-on-1. End-to-end action we go. In front, score! with just 9.2 seconds remaining on the power play. Brad MacArthur brings the Knighthawks within one.
Rochester did exactly what Philadelphia should have done on the other way. Reggie Thorpe is a playmaker. He's a ground ball guy. He takes it down the floor. He passes it off. He's not a scorer. He does the right thing. He gives it to a scorer. He gives it to MacArthur. MacArthur jams in the back of the net. Draws the defender. Great shot. Beats Dowse the upper right-hand corner. If you even go back further to that play, Larry, you saw Peter Jacobs coming down the floor. He's not our big scorer. You got Kevin Finneran on the left-hand side. If Jacobs had dunked it to Finneran, he probably would have been there for the goal, and it would have been the Wings goal versus the Rochester goal.
Or at least you'd have good floor balance. The period comes to a conclusion on that check against McAvoy by Jeremy Hollenbach. But the Brad MacArthur goal, his first goal of the season for the former St. Andrews College All-American, cuts the lead to 4-3. Dallas Elliott's been stellar. 16-9, the shots on goal advantage belongs to Philadelphia in that first period play. And it's Jake showing him that right leg and over the shoulder for a 4-2 lead. MacArthur in the final 10 seconds with a little dunk put away to make it 4-3. That is how we stand. Scott and I coming back with period number two from the First Union Center in a moment.
What better way to enjoy Philadelphia Wings lacrosse games than to go with your favorite friends to the First Union Center? The Wings offer a group sales discount for parties of 20 or more. Or celebrate a special birthday that includes game tickets, visits from Mad Dog, and Wings party favors. Families love Wings games. A family of four pack that includes four tickets, four soft drinks, and four hot dogs is just $66. Call 215-389-WINGS for more package info and how to become a season ticket holder. Wings lacrosse, it's always a party.
In your world, job stress means more than emotional anxiety. It means real physical damage, like injured or arthritic knees. When making a living takes a toll on your body, call Penn Orthopedics. Our doctors serve as specialists for pro and college teams and are consistently ranked among the nation's best. We'll fix you up, because keeping you in working order is what our job is all about. Call Penn Orthopedics at 1-800-789-PENN.
Where can you get great-tasting food and feel like you're in the heart of Little Italy? Eastside Mario's in Exton, of course. Eastside Mario's, where you're surrounded by the sights, sounds, and aroma of New York's Little Italy. Enjoy our famous warm garlic home loaf and all-you-can-eat super salad. Eastside Mario's is a great meeting place. Have a drink at the bar, or bring the family in for some delicious pasta, chicken, seafood, herb crust pizza, and more. Stop into Eastside Mario's today, located on Route 30 in Exton, across from the Exton Square Mall.
Hello everyone, I'm Ron Jaworski, and I want to tell you about all my friends at Warwick Jewelers in Exton. The staff at Warwick are experienced professionals who are willing and able to help you choose just the right gift, whether it's a special occasion or for every day. They can even design one-of-a-kind pieces, too. And you can be sure you're getting a fair price, because it's done right here. For quality craftsmanship, master goldsmiths, and superior customer service, stop into Warwick Jewelers in the Whiteland Town Center today.
Set to open action period number two. Let's turn over a new leaf with Leif Elsbone.
Well, guys, the success of the Wings will be dependent on how they play John Grant. You've seen all the beef we talked about. Jacobs and company play tough defense on him. The one goal he scored was when McAvoy got caught on him. John McAvoy gave too much room. Grant just stung a little low shot. That was not the matchup they prefer, and it was way too much room. When they get the matchups, they've been doing a great job pounding Grant into the boards.
Thank you, Leif. Yeah, we'll take it back. As we are set indeed for action period two. Grant, as you said, not extraordinarily strong, not extraordinarily fast, or as dynamic an athlete, just a magnificent lacrosse player.
Just great stick work and great shooting ability.
Philadelphia with the first possession. Will change on the go. Jake Berge's got it. Jake with a goal and two assists in that first period. Maracek wide. Little two-man game set up. A lot of cutters looking for Clark through the slot and up and do it. So we'll come on this side.
Very good defenders on the Rochester team as well. Good matchup, though, for Tom Maracek and Jake Berge. They're going to try to work the pick and roll on their side as you see it setting up. It worked for him last time with a goal by Berge, and you just keep coming at it till it works.
Rebound, score. No, they're waving it off. Waving it off. Crease violation on Radebaugh.
Nice effort by Sean Radebaugh to be there for the second chance. For the second chance effort, unfortunately, was in the cage. Tommy Maricek takes the shot. Radebaugh toes the line, but just gets in there, and they take the goal away. From this angle, it looks good. He kept his toes outside. Bad call by the official.
Still 4-3. Philadelphia by one. In the mix section, handled by Dallas Elliott.
Dallas is really playing strong tonight. He's making the big saves with the players on top of him. We highlight that. Seems like we do it every time we do a game. But Dallas is on. He can stop people from anywhere.
Terrific duck inside, but the shot never reaches the net off Finneran. Loose in front. Ryan can't come up with it. And it's picked off the floor by Dan Tate.
A lot of mayhem in front of the net there.
Malowski back to Tate. Ridden hard into the floor. And foul be called on Ryan. No penalty.
Great save by Dallas with the Knighthawk coming right down and right on top of him. Ryan gives him a push from behind. It's going to be a possession going back to Rochester.
Terrific job handling the rebounds as well. That's Casey Powell. Powell gets the screen. Trying to find his way down the slot as the action comes back toward the top of the slot. Shot well placed. Perfect shot. Rusty Kerger had a tiny little bit of a crease that Dallas gave him on the far post and didn't whip it, just placed it.
Great shooters. It shows the strength of John Grant getting pounded. He flips a little pass behind his back. The only place that the shot can go is to the left-hand elbow of Dallas Elliott, and that's where Kruger puts it. Right there, takes a good look, bangs it to the opposite pipe. That's John Grant Jr. again. He's gonna take the pounding from the defender. Normally a guy's ready, waiting for an overhand pass, but John Grant whips it over the shoulder for a beautiful assist.
We're tied at four. Penalty boxes are empty, by the way. As Rochester's found their legs a little bit, back-to-back goals to tie it at four. And a whistle. And again, way off the ball. We've got a foul called. Tony wants an explanation. That's Tony Resch. Sixth year as the head coach. Looking dapper as always.
Well, it looks like that there was a little bit of extracurriculars going on down in the left-hand corner with John Grant and Jamie Hanford. Not sure if that's going to be a penalty or not.
Doors are closed.
But it looks like something was going on down there. I don't know if we can pick it up on a replay, but it looks as if the Rochester player was giving him a little bit of business after the play, and he's going to send him to the box.
Yep, Philadelphia will have a man advantage as they'll send Jeremy Hollenbeck, the defender, into the penalty box. And Philadelphia, there you see him. Philadelphia will take the man advantage.
Here's the power play for Philadelphia, tied at 4-4. Be a great opportunity to take the lead right now. Philadelphia gets into their rotation, gets a play work, and see if they can capitalize.
Bang, a little bit of a fresh look. Whistle, and it'll be Philadelphia possession. They certainly could have played the advantage.
Got a change in the lineup here. You've got Tom Fair down low right at the shooter spot, replacing John McAvoy for this series. Tom Fair is a poised shooter and often gets worked down there. Here's the shot from behind. Tom Maricek showing you what kind of check you can take in the boards.
Cycling through. Philadelphia offensive attack. That's wide. Good scoop to keep it in the offensive zone. Finneran throws it all the way across into some heavy traffic. And then it's led well in front of Dan Tate, who cannot come up with it, then just kind of swipes it wide before he winds up face down on this brand new beautiful carpet. The carpet purchased from the U.S. Women's Pro Tour that came through Philadelphia a month or so ago. And the deep green really is very impressive. Again, a near turnover from Maricek. It's loose on the floor, picked up by Fair. And that'll be over and back.
Bad turnover for Philadelphia, just very unsettled. Somebody needs to just take control, take some leadership out on the man up to get them settled down and set up their offensive play.
Very vocal coach is young Mr. Resch. especially when his man advantage unit is not necessarily performing up to the capabilities. Powell's got it at midfield.
Need to regroup. Now, again, here's the penalty killing team for Rochester. They have their man down. Are they going to kill the clock or they go right at it? They decide to go right at it and bang. That's tough. That is tough. That can really take the steam out of a team. When you've got five guys against four, Rochester takes it to the hoop and gets a goal.
Powell really makes this play.
He sets it up. He's very slippery. You see him turning on a dime. Dewey Jacobs has a fantastic stick. He's tough. He gets it with a man draped all over him. Takes the left-hand shot. Looks like he beats Dallas to the five hole.
Wow. Dwayne Jacobs is the all-time leader in goals and assists for this franchise.
Fantastic player, Dwayne Jacobs. He's been around in the league for a long time. He's made his way to some championships with the Rochester Knighthawks. He's got a very accurate shot, and he's good inside. So he beats Philadelphia for a goal right there.
Still 20 seconds man advantage. Philadelphia down one. Faking in front, off the left shoulder, right shoulder rather, from the shot from Maracek. Good dodge in front again. They're trying to go high, away from the stick side.
Got a new 30, take some of the air out of it, set it up.
That's wide and handled in the crease by Mike Hasen. Outlet, Finneran's got it. Shot clock, or the penalty clock just expired. 2-on-0 in front, and again that same spot that Maracek went for. Great, high glove side.
Great save by O'Toole. Normally Tom Maracek in front of the net is going to cash that one in. Pat O'Toole with a big save there to his right-hand side. Rochester looking to use their two-man game here. A lot of pick and rolls coming out of Rochester. This is the big defensive line that we talked about in the open. Tom Slate, Peter Jacobs, Andy Towers, John McAvoy, Jason Clark. You've got the Twin Towers out there in 6'4 and 6'5 and Jacobs and Towers, and then some of our smaller guys in McAvoy and Clark. Good defensive effort by Philadelphia on that last play.
That was a deflection, so it remains Rochester possession. Coming down off that off wing, Powell with a great catch, shot by Grant, never reaches the net as it's broken down in front. Rochester getting to a lot of loose balls over the last 8 or 9 minutes of play, and Powell continues. Now, little shovel in front, three-man game shot. That was off the post on the hop. And a whistle as the arm goes up in the air. I believe Gary Martin, the assistant coach, saying, what are you pointing at us for?
A little bit of a defensive breakdown by Philadelphia there. They were not matched up on their offensive players, and it looks like it led to a penalty. I'm not sure where it came from, but with all the chaos that was going on down there at defensive end, there was a man left open. And they got the shot. John Grant hit the pipe on the crossbar, and now Philadelphia's going to go to their man down situation.
It's a beautiful play in front. And by now, the whistle and the penalty had apparently been sounded. The door is open, but the box is still empty.
Well, here's the
Bechminer, maybe?
I think it might have been a cross check. On Jacobs coming up into Powell on that last pass. But regardless, Rochester's in the power play. Here you have John Grant Jr. up top. Casey Powell is the right-hand shooter, number 99.
That's Powell.
Rochester has a very tough extra man, so look for interesting things to happen here.
Keeping it hot, as they seem to do on almost every possession. And again, they scoop the loose ball. Whistle.
Nice defense by Dave Stille to break up that shot that was coming. He almost had a big, big hit on that play, but he got called for the push.
On Rusty Kerger. And Grant and Powell. It was a bench minor for too many men on the floor.
Sloppy passes by Rochester, and Philadelphia takes advantage of it.
Long pass trying to thread the needle. Bergie's got it off the hop. Shot, score! He beat Grant, used Grant as a screen, and buried it. We're tied at five.
John Grant got a stick on that pass, almost broke down the whole play, but Jake Bergie staying with the play, picks up the ground ball, takes a look at the net, and puts it home. Matt Oglesby sees Bergie streaking. Grant can't control the ball, tries to play some defense, hits the five hole. Grant making an all or nothing check, trying to go over his head. Bergie takes the shot, finishes it home, five hole on the goalie. Nice left-hand corner of the shot. Jake Berg had a shorthanded goal. Very nice opportunity by Philadelphia.
Jake, one of the best high school lacrosse players in Delaware's recent history, against one of the top collegiate players ever at Delaware, John Grant. We're tied at five. And Grant, with that little wraparound looking for the top of his head, Jake shakes that off like a mosquito bite.
That's not an effective check in this game.
Off the pipe by Kerger on the rebound as he cleaned it up brilliantly but couldn't bury the shot. Philadelphia is still shorthanded, remember, for 53 seconds, even though we're tied at five. Too much room in front, over the shoulder wraparound by Grant. Dallas read it, saw it all the way, and they'll use Dallas to break pressure. Good outlet from Dallas to Peter Jacobs, who will wait. 35 seconds and counting, man advantage. And Philadelphia can pretty much rag this shorthanded situation down.
It's the penalty killing unit. Again, it's a strategy as what are you gonna do? When you get Jake Berg up top, you're often gonna go right to the hoop.
There he goes. Jake couldn't get that one on net. And they will call the shot clock violation. Now play continues. Last 10 seconds, man advantage. Wonderful matchup tonight between Philadelphia and Rochester. Very physical confrontation with terrific skill. Score.
Put in a
low whipper.
Put in a whole new unit for Rochester. Tim Sudan, Randy Mearns, bunch of guys that have been in this game for a long time. They get it done. Randy Mearns takes the ball up top. Dwayne Jacobs passes it over. They get a full rotation of this play. And then a big shot from Tim Sudan from the outside right. Great ball movement by Rochester. Tim Sudan takes a good look, beats Dallas to the lower right-hand corner.
Well placed for the veteran Sudan. It came with 1 second on the penalty, so that will officially go as a power play goal. And Rochester a 6-5 lead. We reached the midway point of period number two, with the Knighthawks a 6-5 lead over the Wings of Philadelphia. With Scott Gabros and I'm Larry Rosick. Glad you are with us for National Lacrosse League action as that one winds up over top the Rochester bench. A couple of smiling fans in the good seats. And we will take a break. So Philadelphia with a 6-5 disadvantage against Rochester on their own home floor. And make your next birthday party a huge hit. Come and celebrate your birthday with the Philadelphia Wings. Simply call us at 215-389-WINGS to book your birthday party here with Philadelphia's Wings. We've got shorthanded goals, man advantage goals, and a very vocal coach. Back in a moment.
Must be boat show time. The Atlantic City International Power Boat Show, February 2nd through the 6th, America's largest indoor power boat show. Must be boat show time. The Atlantic City International Power Boat Show, February 2nd through the 6th, America's largest indoor power boat show.
Welcome. The National Lacrosse League presents Indoor Lacrosse. Hard hits and quick sticks.
Next Saturday, February 5th, is Drew Carey Night here at the First Union Center. The Wings host the New York Saints. Great seats still available at the box office or by calling 215-336-2000. Coach Resch's club down 1-6-5 exactly midway through the second period of play here at the First Union Center.
Here's a goal again by Jake Berge. Just great presence of mind to pick up the loose ball, takes a nice shot from outside, scores from the outside. Then Tim Sudan with a great outside shot. Defense is a little lax on it. Sudan pounds it down low.
Rochester's been dominant, at least in terms of shots on goal in period number two. As they spread the floor again, go into their half court set. Very well schooled, well disciplined. Double screen, shot, score. That's a beautiful set play. Of course, we're upstairs and you can really see it develop. That's lovely, the goal for Dwayne Jacobs.
Rochester's very active on their offense, a lot of movement inside. Here's Dwayne Jacobs, who said it earlier that the guy's a deadly shooter. He gets a pass up top, takes a good look at the net, bang, sticks it up top, crossbar. Again, Malowski takes it down low, sets up Jacobs, beats Dalseliak to the top corner. He's not the kind of guy that you let sit and take a look at the net uncontested, because he will burn you for a goal.
7-5 Knighthawks. Philadelphia, by the way, 0-2 on the man advantage. Rochester 3-4.
The Wings need to improve their shooting on net. To see that shots on goal of the Knighthawks versus the Wings, the disparity between those two numbers are not what the Philadelphia Wings goals were to achieve tonight.
Yeah, Philadelphia just 4 shots on in the first 8 minutes of this period. Towers has it, tries the over-the-shoulder Weekly, score! Not Weekly, Maracek with the wrap.
Wow, Tom Maracek. Staying down low. Normally you want to get some guys, you want to get back on defense. He stays in front of the goalie. It knocks down the pass. Andy Towers picks up the loose ball, flips it behind his back to Tom Maracek, and flips it behind his back. Here you go. Towers flips behind his back. Tommy takes a look at the net, flips it behind his for a nice goal. Great presence of mind, great effort by Tom Maracek. Here you go. Hollywood celebrating the goal afterwards. Well done, Tommy.
How about Andy Towers? Hasn't played in 5 years. On the floor with a guy like Maracek. Float him a little butterfly out front and see what he can do with it.
I normally prefer to see an overhand pass on that play, but it worked out for Andy Towers to get it to Tom Maracek.
One goal game once more as McAvoy and Berge out front begin this Philadelphia rush. That came all the way through. Clark's got it. He's been quiet tonight. Clark shovels it in front again over the shoulder, the off shoulder that time for Maracek.
Great forechecking by Philadelphia.
A whistle. Looks like a penalty to be called on Maracek.
A little too aggressive off the ball.
Well, Tony's preaching aggressiveness.
Big cross check. From behind with possession of the ball. Reggie Thorpe's normally all over the ground balls in this game. He has that when he had possession. Tommy gave him a cross check right directly to the back. He's going to the box for 2 minutes.
Maracek's 4th minor of the young season at the 6:04 mark.
It's not a position that you want to be in for Philadelphia. The man up or the power play for Rochester is very effective. So let's see how the defensive rotation works for Philadelphia.
Grant and Powell working their way in. Grant fakes, now Powell. That one deflected off a stick in front. It's loose and scooped by Philadelphia. Peter Jacobs will stop. They go wing to wing for Slate. Slate has a look at it and backs it out.
Smart play, excellent clear by the Philadelphia Wings. Great ball movement to get it away from the bench. Push it down the floor. Now they're gonna get their better stick handlers on the field to let them try to get an offensive effort.
Ryan tried the centering pass for Finneran. Broken down. And back with the man advantage, Jacobs. He'll wait for Powell. Powell the hop into 360. Crosses off the bench, back to Grant.
A lot of times in the power play, you dictate who you want to take the shot.
Stilley on the outlet, Oglesby with a break. Matt, the scoop, and he will wait, looking in front as he had a man coming down. That's Hanford. And it's the big Jake Berge show at center field. Now 40 seconds on the Maracek penalty.
Great feat by Jake Berge. Here you have the full offensive extra man unit for Rochester playing defense now. That's normally a mismatch. Your best offensive players normally are not your best defensive players, but they stay down there in that end to play D. But with the 30-second shot, they get the ball back, and we'll see how they can pull out this offensive possession.
Nice forechecking Ryan for Philadelphia as he comes off. Penalty clock down to 20 seconds. Philadelphia in that deep box. Grant at the top. There he is. Shot off the stick to save from Elliott. Dallas comes out of his area to make the save. Now with 3-2, door is open and Maracek is free at last. As he comes up the wing, accepts the pass from Jacobs. Maracek stumbles, regains his footing, takes it behind with inside of 4 minutes remaining. Period two, Finneran. Finneran gets alone in front, and that's a left foot save. Look what I found for Pat O'Toole. Fine outlet.
Great save by O'Toole. He's starting this whole play.
In front on the rebound. Picked up there by Mearns. Again, the wraparound alone in front. Score.
Defensive breakdown by Philadelphia. The defensive player got caught up in front of the net on that switch, leaving Malowski on the just totally naked on the right-hand side in front of the net. That's such a hard shot to stop, and he cans it.
They look like they kickstart a lot off coming around from behind, or is that just the flow of play as we've seen it?
It's a strategic play. It's a great sneak play by Malowski. Comes around the net, sets up, still he's late to slide, or slides to the wrong side of the floor. Malowski's there, sets up Dallas, fakes to the right, jams it to the left.
8-6 Knighthawks. The Knighthawks extremely aggressive in the offensive end. And here they come again.
Rochester's controlling the ground balls, therefore they're on the offensive floor a lot more often than Philadelphia is right now.
Score by Grant, again over the left shoulder, and he hops up into the sideboards. What a bit of a homecoming. You wonder if as a youngster he came to Philadelphia to watch his dad play.
He probably did, but it's nice to make his own debut on his own terms and conditions here in Philadelphia.
Absolutely.
He's so strong, he's a big guy. Two hands on the stick, fakes behind his back, takes it with the upper hand, right hand shot, buries it past Dallas. The guy's tough, he's gonna be tough. You gotta have a strong defender on him. He's gonna go through your normal checks. May have not been the matchup that Philadelphia wanted with Matt Oglesby. You wanted a guy like Jacobs, you see there, you wanted some of our size, covering the size of the Rochester Knighthawks.
Timeout called by Rochester, up 9-6. On the road, as noted, first couple of games, the Knighthawks 23-11 in first halves. And they have now built their biggest lead of the evening with a 6-2 second period advantage over Philadelphia. Overall, they lead it 9-6.
In the financial world, once money leaves your hands, it enters a vast global system of transactions. Keeping track of it can be difficult, especially if your accounts are divided among different institutions. But if they're consolidated with First Union, you have easy access by phone, online, ATM, or in person. To control your financial life, come to the mountain called First Union. Or if you prefer, the mountain will come to you.
10 Championships is an amazing video that brings you 90 minutes of the year's best lacrosse action, including men's NCAA Division I, II, and III finals, women's Division I and III, the exciting NLL Championship, the Vail Lacrosse Shootout, the USCLA Club Finals, and other memorable games filled with today's top stars. Simply send $24.95 to LAX TV, Box 3302, Annapolis, Maryland, 21403.
Late period two, Philadelphia down 3, the view from the bench in Lee Felsmo.
Well, guys, Tony Rush talked about two things. One, defensively, they're playing John Grant great in his face, but they cannot let him track from one side to the other like he did last time. Secondly, on offense, he screamed at the team to move the ball. He said, we're carrying it way too much. Up top to you.
Thank you, Leaf.
It's not a game about individuals. It's a team game. You need to move the ball to create the opportunities. Rochester's done it, and they've been scoring the goals. Philly needs to get back on track.
Good double team.
There's a great defensive effort by Tom Fair. Brought in Tom Fair as a defensive specialist. He wraps up Casey Powell, creates the turnover.
Oglesby getting his stick held, but still working it through. Then the shovel pass as he takes two guys down. Jacobs, your trailer shot. O'Toole able to hold that between the stick and the pad. Play continues. All that started by fine defensive work by Philadelphia in the near corner.
Here's a matchup that you wanted. You have Jacobs on John Grant Jr. Good defense, takes probably an ill-advised shot from that out that far, and Dallas makes the easy save.
And Jacobs precluded him from coming all the way from one side across to the other, as Leaf intimated a focal point of that last time out. Last 2 minutes, first half, Finneran accepts to the middle, shot wide of the near side. High, long rebound is still loose on the floor. Three wings come near it. Comes out to Clark. Clark, the centering pass, shots blocked down. Finneran tried to go low and will get a shot clock violation at the 1:35 mark.
Finn seems a little uncertain with his shots from outside. He needs to catch the ball, take a look at the goal, and shoot it. He's getting a little uneasy with his shots here.
Kevin on Philadelphia's bench. In the slot. Over the shoulder shot is high and wide from Sudan. He is slow getting up and limping his way toward the Rochester bench as Philadelphia tries in transition. Maracek off the bench, his shot's blocked by Tate in front. Shot that one by Slate. Will reset the shot clock as it catches a little pipe.
A lot of shots are being knocked down in front of the goal before they even get to O'Toole.
Radabaugh takes the hop step, that's over the top. Ooh, Ryan did a nice job to corral that rebound, but could not bring it up into shooting position and rolled off his stick.
Big shutoff by Philadelphia onto excellent defensive effort.
Long shovel pass from Hasten in front. Now they have it over the shoulder. Dallas read it. Fine read in front as bodies again go down. And Philadelphia comes up with a 4-on-2. With 25 seconds remaining. Hot shot off the near pipe.
Two quick pipes for Sean Radabaugh, an errant pass. John Grant had a streaking offensive player coming down the floor.
MacArthur was 40 feet behind the defense. Could not come up with that pass, and now a whistle with 4.6 seconds remaining.
Very sloppy play in the ground balls by both teams. They had some excellent opportunities there. Rochester did on a breakaway down the floor. Couldn't make the pass, didn't pick up the ground ball. Tony Rush is gonna regroup. Here it is, kind of a lazy shot, gets taken out afterwards. Grant flips it. Big, big whack by Dallas. He's gonna give it to you if you're in front of the net and that ball's loose.
So 4.6 seconds remaining in what has been an outstanding second period for the Knighthawks of Rochester.
Nice timeout by Tony Resch. Things were very scrambled. We needed to regroup. Philadelphia Wings got the guys in. Gary Martin's talking the defense, talking the offense, telling them what they need to do to really be more effective. Got to settle yourself down.
Is 4.6 enough to get something done? Are there set plays? Is Tony one of those?
Well, with the shooters that the Philadelphia Wings have, I would say that Tom Maracek's going to end up with this ball.
Well, Dallas Elick in the net has always been a very physical player. Boom, caught a little bit of his teammate as he swung that big waffle.
Dallas has been known to chop down a few trees in his day, and there's evidence of it.
Shot! Big save off the left arm, right arm from Jake Berge, as they did get a nice shot out of it. So indeed a fine timeout, Tony Resch, to get Jake one more opportunity, but the club will go into the locker room at the half, trailing 9-6, as Rochester has pretty much done whatever they needed to do in period number two, mostly by accepting ground balls and finding some of their star players into positions they're most successful, like this one, Grant, who works his way.
Here's the strength of John Grant, going right to the shot.
Kaboom! Back with our halftime festivities for you in just a moment.
The Phantoms battle their arch-rival Hershey Bears on Friday, February 18th at 7:05 at the First Union Spectrum. Following the game, 7,500 fans will receive a dog toy, courtesy of Hill's Science Diet and Petco. Call 215-336-2000.
Snyder's of Hanover has been baking pretzels for almost a century. Pretzels crafted from old world recipes and slow baked to perfection. With over 20 varieties, there's a favorite for everyone. Visit the Pretzel Bakery in the Snyder's section of your grocery store today.
Snyder's pretzels are munchably, crunchably, got a hunch they're gonna be
the finest bakery pretzels anywhere.
Snyder's of Hanover, America's pretzel bakery since 1909.
The new Garnet Volkswagen Clubhouse is here. Are you ready? Garnet Volkswagen, located on Route 202 just north of Route 1 in Chads Ford.
Hey, nothing like a really good newspaper, but if you're still using one of these to find a job, then maybe you're not being too serious about your career. Yeah, sure, some of those national virtual job sites are fine if you're looking to relocate to, say, Fargo, North Dakota. But if you're looking for local jobs, local companies, then check out jobnet.com/radius. It's a local thing, jobnet.com/radius. It's your career. Make it happen.
Back to our National Cross League action, 9-6. The Knighthawks lead the hometown Philadelphia Wings. I'm Lee Felsmo back at the beginning of our halftime with Tony Resch, who wants to get into the locker room. Tony, a 9-6, three goals down. Your team focused on John Grant, his great talent. You have big body matchups in your game plan, and when you get those matchups, it works well. Early in the game, his first goal, you had John get on him, and that was a bad matchup. Gave him a little bit too much room. He scores.
Yeah, I mean, he's a very talented player. I mean, the one thing about Rochester is they're a very balanced team. So we obviously wanted to pay attention to where John Grant was, but they can hurt you in a lot of ways. So they're tough to play because they're not a flash team, but they wear you down. And when you make a mistake, you pay for it. And we made some mistakes, especially in the mid-latter part of the second quarter. And good teams cash in, and they hurt us when we made mistakes. So we have to correct and not make mistakes. It's a tall order, but... we knew that coming in. We're going to have to get back to basics and play a little smarter and harder.
Very quickly, on the positive side, you caught him on defense, made him play defense, burned him both times.
Yeah, I mean, you have to find the correct matchups and take advantage of them. And, you know, we've had a couple good opportunities late, and then they just didn't go in. But we're going to keep working at it and hopefully get a couple to fall.
It's anybody's game. Tony Resch will go into the halftime. Come back with our halftime in just a moment right here with Philadelphia down by 3, 9-6.
Roger, squad leader, we've got them covered. Lock on target and fire at will.
Tickets to the Philadelphia Wings' next home game are on sale now. The Wings take on their arch rivals from Long Island, the New York Saints. This Saturday night, 7:30 at the First Union Center. Tickets to all 2000 season home games are on sale at Ticketmaster or call 215-336-2000. Join the team. Get your tickets now. Because they're coming in hot.
So, you thought nothing was bigger than the Big New Yorker Pizza. Well, how about a chance to make your own CD? Free at CD Now. That's right. Order the Big New Yorker from Pizza Hut for only $9.99, and we'll give you your own personal access code. Go online to cdnow.com and choose 6 songs from a selection of over 75 artists and 200 hits. Personalize your own CD, then we'll mail it to you. Free. We make the pizza, you'll make the CD. Hey, I told you this was big. The Big New Yorker, another one of the best pizzas under one roof.
So what, an interception?
Everybody throws interceptions.
Missed field goal?
Nothing to be ashamed of. Fumbles happen. Nobody's perfect. So what we lost? So what? What's important is how you play the game.
Get sports the way Philly sees it. Watch Sports Rise mornings at 6 and Sports Night evenings at 6:30 and 10. Only on Comcast Sportsnet. Totally Philly. Totally sports.
Who needs a hug? You, number 35, you need a hug? Who needs a hug?
The undefeated Rochester Knighthawks with a 9-6 halftime lead over the Philadelphia Wings. It's a chance for us to take a peek inside the game with a gentleman that spent most of his adult life wearing the silver and black of Philadelphia, Scott Gabrielson. Here's Scott's view from down on the floor.
Tonight we're going to take you inside the game of indoor lacrosse. One of the most basic fundamental offensive plays is the simple pick and roll. A lot of people are familiar with it in the game of basketball, where a pick is set on the ball side carrier, dump pass comes inside, and the rolling player gets an easy two. Tonight we're going to show it to you in the game of indoor lacrosse because it is one of the most basic plays. To help me demonstrate this are wing stars Jake Berge, John McAvoy, and Tom Slate. Tom and I are going to represent the defensive players in this drill, while John and Jake are going to represent the offensive players. How it sets up is like this. My defensive responsibility is to cover the ball carrier, at which time the other offensive player sets a blindside pick on my side, which creates a situation where Tom, as my teammate, must stay with his defensive responsibility or slide to Jake. As he goes through and makes that slide, Jake Berge makes the dump to John McAvoy for the simple pick and roll. We're going to run through it in fast motion to show you how it works. Here we go. As I look set up on Jake Berge, the blindside pick is made, the dump comes, and the shot is made. Here are a few examples in live game situations.
Mac Giles dishing it off. Squire down low. Here's a chance to score. Now to Maracek.
Toronto successfully killed the second goal.
Maracek gets it over top. Finneran.
There are a couple examples of the pick and roll in the game of indoor lacrosse. They're the basic fundamental plays that open great scoring opportunities for the offensive players. As you watch the game tonight, keep your eye on it and see how well it's executed.
Well done, Scotty. We'll come back. A couple of pick and roll goals in that first half of play. We'll have first half highlights and analysis for you and much, much more in just a moment.
I can't believe we're here. It's so beautiful. What are you doing?
Marry me?
You can never be too prepared.
Will you marry me?
That's why Pico Energy people are intensely trained for emergency response. Because when you're ready, nothing throws you. Pico Energy, no doubt about it.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Serious. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. Warburg.com.
Championships is an amazing video that brings you 90 minutes of the year's best lacrosse action, including men's NCAA Division 1, 2, and 3 finals, women's Division 1 and 3, the exciting NLL Championship, the Vail Lacrosse Shootout, the USCLA Club Finals, and other memorable games filled with today's top stars. Simply send $24.95 to LAX TV, Box 3302, Annapolis, Maryland, 21403.
You had to do it, didn't you? Had to show those 19-year-olds you could still play the game. Well, you showed them, all right. You showed them the alley-oop ligament tear. Time to call Penn Orthopedics. Our sports medicine experts care for the Eagles and the Flyers and are consistently ranked among the nation's best. We'll fix you up, too. And we'll even keep a straight face when you tell us what happened. Call Penn Orthopedics at 1-800-789-PENN.
And we welcome you back to the First Union Center. Rochester a 9-6 halftime lead, and our first chance to look at John Grant Jr. Indeed, he's been a revelation in that first half.
Showing why he is the number one draft pick in the NLL. The guy's got a fantastic shot, as you're seeing from outside. And then he shows the power, fakes behind his back, bangs it past Dalicelli for a big goal.
He has two goals and two assists. That's Dwayne Jacobs, the all-time leading scorer in the history of the Rochester franchise, also with two goals and with two assists. And you see three assists for Powell, has yet to score a goal, now with three goals and eight assists on the season, as they get a nine-goal first half. Rochester's been an outstanding first-half team all year. For Philadelphia, again, they're led tonight by Jake.
You got Jake Berge and Maracek teaming up right here for a goal. Tom Maracek just with an amazing shot wrapped around his shoulder, puts it between the five-hole of the goaltender.
Berge with two goals, two assists. Maracek with two goals, has yet to register an assist. Philadelphia down at the half by the count of 9-6. First half statistics are indicative. The shots about even, saves also about even. Power play opportunities, therein lies the difference in the contest. You have a three-goal deficit, Scotty, and you see that you've given up three power plays, and worse, you get the score on your own.
The power plays, you have to take advantage. Those are two goals that you should have when you have those opportunities. The loose balls, 54-35, is a great stat for Philadelphia. They're swarming the ball, they're taking advantage of it. That's a nice stat to see, but when the Rochester Knighthawks get the power play, they're cashing in, they're taking advantage of it.
Philadelphia's gonna need a strong second half comeback, and likely it'll be led by that guy, Jake Berge, with a pair of first half goals, a pair of first half assists. Philadelphia down by three. We'll come back with third quarter action for you from the First Union Center in just a moment.
I need some gasoline.
I'm going across the country to prove that everyone loves the taste of Pepsi One.
Oh, yelp.
How's it taste?
Tastes like the one to me.
Taste the deliciousness. What do you think of the taste?
Can't believe it's only one calorie.
Bob and me, it tastes good.
Pepsi One, a secret formula, makes it taste too good to be called diet.
It's very good.
Pepsi One, true cold taste, one calorie.
The Big Five City Series is in mid-season form as the St. Joe's Hawks venture into the Palestra to take on Michael Jordan and the Penn Quakers Monday at 6:30. College basketball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Toyota.
Sunday is a very special day, and we've got a very special Angelo and Company. Wing Bowl number 8. All of the eaters, all of the babes, all of the pageantry. We're going to have that in a special one-hour show, noon and midnight, right here on Angelo.
First, Europe's most coveted design award. Now, honored as the highest quality luxury sedan in America, the Volvo S80. My goodness.
Stillman Volvo, Route 202, 2 miles north of Route 1 in Westchester. Volvo for life.
Volkswagen Clubhouse is here. Are you ready? Garnet Volkswagen, located on Route 202, just north of Route 1 in Chads Ford.
2-0 record and a pair of the most young, dynamic players in all of the National Lacrosse League with a 2-0 lead. The league beginning to take some shape as you look at the standings for the first couple of weeks of play. Toronto at 3-0. Philadelphia at 1-1, a game and a half back. Rochester at 2-0. Any major surprises to your eyes?
Just great parity throughout the league. It's going to be interesting this year.
Well, fired up halftime speech came from Paul Day, and now he's going to share a moment with Lee Elsmo. Gentlemen.
All right, fellas, I've got Paul Day, 3-goal lead. Your assessment of that first half?
I thought we had a bit of a tough start and a bit of a tough finish there, but luckily Patty O'Toole stood in there and saved us at the end.
Looks like they're putting a lot of beef on John Grant.
Yeah, I mean, obviously they're going to put a guy like Jacobs on there. He's a very smart defender. We just got to pick on that instead of trying to get John open, try to get the other guy open that's playing off of John.
Now, defensively, offensively, your team, as always, you move the ball 3 or 4 times, you seem to kill people.
Yeah, and I think that we've been trying to stress that. They're playing a really wide open defensive style. If everybody gets 3 or 4 passes, it spreads them out that much more, and then we can pick off the ball.
Patty O'Toole goes the whole way?
As far as I hope he's going the whole way. He's playing well so far.
All right, he's got a great goalie situation. His team leads by 3.
Thanks very much. When he says Philadelphia's playing a wide open defensive style there for 3 or 4 touches, what's he going for?
He's just saying that the ball movement creates the offense, and if they're gonna focus on John Grant, they're gonna focus on the rolling man, so the pick and roll.
And Patty O'Toole, who his coach says will likely be in. Dietrich, an extraordinary keeper as well. But O'Toole has played very strongly in that first period, unable to rattle him.
He's played very well. The Philadelphia Wings really did a lot of work on looking at Pat O'Toole, where his weaknesses are, and he's beating the Wings so far with a lot of big saves against their shooters.
It's like they're playing him high glove side, and he's got that elbow strong. There you see it. And we're underway, period 3. Philadelphia down 3, immediately a whistle as McAvoy was put down. We'll get Philadelphia possession so they can change on the go. McAvoy, Jacobs, Buzza, the defensive crew, heads off. And Berkey accepts. And here we go. They set up a two-man game on the near side. Maracek dives in, switches, gets hooked. And we've got a whistle. Mike Hasen. Looks like he's heading immediately for the penalty box, just 14 seconds in.
Great matchup. Tom Maracek's one of the best Dodgers on Philadelphia, him and Berge. Hasen can't stay with Tommy, comes down from left to right, gets him up under the chin, around the neck. He's headed to the box for 2 minutes.
He is the all-time penalty minutes leader. That got caught with the hook.
It's a great matchup. If Hasen's going to be covering Tom Maracek takes it to the goal. Same with Berge. It all depends on who's covering on defense.
Maracek, Berge, left wing. Kind of static offensively, 4 out, trying to keep the slot open. Maracek, Berge. Kind of fanned on that pass, but it got through to fair nonetheless. Maracek scores! And the arms go high.
He saved me from saying it, but I was just about to say we need some offense, some production out of the power play. And just then, Tom Maracek takes a big shot from outside. To be effective, the outside shooters need to be a threat. Tommy takes a good look at the net, bang, punches the upper right-hand corner. He's got a deadly accurate shot, and right there, he shows his accuracy.
Look at the placement.
Great angle here, sees the upper, actually the 5-hole, bangs it past O'Toole.
Maracek checking out the replay. 9th goal's 3rd. That's a power play for Philadelphia, their first of the evening. It's a 2-goal deficit. Backcourt violation on Philadelphia. And here comes Powell. Powell dodging Buzza. Gets in front and goes down, and Dallas dives on top. Says thanks for stopping by.
Rochester not really wasting any time here. Philly had a 5-on-4 advantage, and there's no backer on Powell. He comes across, he gets in that no man's land from Eliak, and Eliak gives him a little bit in the back of the head.
So you're in my crease, feel my glove. Again, Maracek dodging, tries the shovel for Berge, and it's loose on the floor, ground ball picked up by Reggie Thorpe, the veteran defender.
That's what he does best. When that ball's on the ground, Reggie Thorpe, number 11, is there for the ground ball. He's a tough player, and he knows his role, and he does it well.
Jacobs flattening it out, gets the screen, looking for the screen roll, dumps it in front on the bounce pass, and Dallas sticks up the big waffle and comes out with it. Oglesby, top of the slot, stops on a dive, finds Berge behind, in front, and that's over the top. Rebound! Scooped up by Orion. Couldn't get that one past Patty O'Toole, but the good pressure continues.
Great forechecking by Philadelphia, staying in their zone, fighting for the ground ball. Instead of running back on defense, they're hustling to get the ground ball. Great effort.
Terrific shift for Ryan. As Rochester tries to move to the offensive zone, again the loose ball, Powell's got it. Dangerous spot, Powell stops on a dime, looks in front, shovels, rebound shot, and the net has been moved back. Rochester's claiming goal. It's behind Dallas. Finally a whistle, possession Philadelphia.
Huge, huge save for Dallas right there. Casey Powell's on the wrong side of four for his hand. He tries to backhand it in the goal. Jacobs has a great opportunity to punch it right in the net, but Dallas closes it up on him. Again, Casey Powell on the wrong side, tries to backhand it. The net comes off its mooring, but Dallas still makes the save.
So it's still 9-7, Knighthawks. Shots on goal, 29, Philadelphia, 28, Rochester. Two apiece in this early third period. Slipping and falling is Holland back, and he felt the Philadelphia defense in front across the crease for the shot from Grant from a bad angle behind Elliott. Shot clock continues to roll, and now the violation. And both teams will fully change.
Nice defense by Philadelphia to use up a full 30 seconds.
And here they come in the offensive sector. Mike Buzz has been relatively quiet, the Penn State veteran. As Oglesby, crossing in front, Slate goes behind, looking for a cutter, comes out back wide. That's Hanford at Buzzer with the screen shot. Easily handled by O'Toole, just bats it to the corner. Shot clock recycles, it's loose on the floor and picked up by Rochester's Reggie Thorpe.
New 30 for Philadelphia. They needed that ground ball, they just couldn't take it. And here comes Rochester again with their offensive line.
Again, the full offense-defense substitution by these Knighthawks. In front, Slate did a nice job defensively to prevent the pass from Kurt Malowski. Three wings fighting, but it's batted free. Comes to Corey Bombery, who's back on the floor after an injury early in the game. In front, as they look for Malowski. New shot clock, bodies fly. Nice pile up near side boards. In the middle of that, Philadelphia's Dave Stille, and Stille gets an extra pop.
Great defense by Dave Stille, All-American out of Duke, one of the toughest guys on the wings this year. Throwing some lumber, just a big strong check, knocks the Rochester Knighthawk down, and then gets the push, it goes the other way.
As Kruger came on top, as the third man in, if you will. Berge the screen, Maracek uses it twice. Can't get the ball in that direction. Brought in front, Clark, he hits a pipe. Lovely spin move by Clark to his offhand. Rochester in transition, stopping. Looking for Grant. Grant with Berge, great matchup. Berge swipes at it, breaks it free. Still on the floor. Now down that off wing, in front. Now bringing around behind. That's Casey Zapp, who gets hammered by Hanford. Eats some glass and a whistle.
Nice defense by Oglesby there up until the last minute. He gave him a push in the back, and he turns it over. They give it back to Rochester.
Berge puts Powell down as he gets his shot free. Sudan behind, shoves it out in front, loose, and Elliott holds his ground. We've got a whistle as Maracek exchanging some pleasantries with Kruger, with the referees in between them. And a lot of yakking. Tommy wants a piece.
He's not going to take any of that. This is a game of intimidation. Some guys can be, some guys can't be. Tom Maracek's not going to be intimidated on the floor. Took a big shot, big check up in the neck. Gets called for the cross check right there, the slash. And then it comes back right to him. Kruger's not very happy about that slash in the neck. Comes right back after Maracek. Maracek's not going to take any of that and gives it right back to him.
Of course, they've got the cages on the face, so that straight right hand caught mostly metal. So I see a lot of stuff around the neck area because it's one of the few highly vulnerable parts
But it's also not a nice place to be hit with a steel shaft, a titanium shaft, let me tell you. And often when you do get hit in the neck like that, you are coming after a guy. So Kruger was coming after Maracek for a reason.
And Maracek wrapped up high, Kruger alone slot 15 feet out, so it wasn't like an off-the-ball kind of a dirty play. It's all he really had was the one swipe to prevent the goal, but he'll wind up in the box. O'Day's club will also have a man down, so it's four aside as we go to Leif Elsmo. Leif.
Hey, fellas, watch John McAvoy, tough guy out there on the field, number 12, playing this man-down unit. The last time he was out there, he took that shot by John Grant in the back as time expired. He has been in the area way here trying to get his breath. He can barely move. Watch how effective he is. He's gutty, but he is very, very sore from that shot in the upper right shoulder blade.
Ouch.
That's not a guy that you want to stop a shot with your back right there. John Grant probably has a shot well over 100 miles per hour. Hard rubber ball going right into John McAvoy's back. He's going to have that with him probably for a few weeks.
But he is back out of the top of the penalty killing unit. On Grant's side, Mearns has it. Now Grant cycles to the top. McAvoy comes to get him, played to Mearns behind the back. What great touch passing, but they can't get the shot away as Stille scoops it for Elliott.
Incredible ball movement by Rochester. What a play. Just shows you the precision and accuracy of the passing in this game of indoor lacrosse. When you can do it well, you do it well. Unfortunately, they couldn't cash in on the shot.
Again, we're four aside. No, we're five aside on the coincidental miners. Berge waiting for his line to set. Oh, the extra miner went against Philadelphia as Towers is also in the box. Violation. Pointing toward Philadelphia's way as Berge was taken into the crease. So Philadelphia will maintain possession. Kruger in the box for Rochester. Towers and Maracek in the box for Philadelphia. So Philadelphia ostensibly in a penalty kill situation. Ryan.
Normally depends on who has the ball in this type of situation, where the matchup is. There's a good backer by Rochester. Dwayne Jacobs was right there. Finn tried to dodge. Jacobs was there to shut it down.
Both sides will change on the go. With less than a minute remaining on the power play, Jacobs to Grant. And again, they keep the slot area open, cycle through, get a lot of touches, shot score. Way up firm and high from Corey Bombery on the assist from Grant, and it's a 10-7 Knighthawk lead.
Wow, that's a heck of a shot. Corey Bombery has one of the best shots in the league, one of the hardest, and that is just a complete tester for Dallas. He's going to go high. If you can see it, if you can stop it, Dallas. Unfortunately,
really?
Dallas couldn't get there, and a fantastic shot by Corey Bombery. Sticks the upper left-hand corner.
It is indeed a power play goal, the fourth power play goal for the Knighthawks. So it's 10-7. 6 minutes, 35 seconds in to period number three. Crowd getting a little bit antsy as Jacobs brings it. Jacobs just had it roll out of his basket. And back they come the other way, shot wide as Buzza hits his man, knocks down Zaff, who was alone in front. The Rochester power play now 4 of 6. And with a three-goal lead, that's the differential. Here's Buzza, the late check. Therefore, possession Rochester. And here they come. Grant flattens it out offensively. Great dodge in front, over the off shoulder and off the outside of the crossbar.
Great hustle by Casey Powell for that diving play. Matt Oglesby, one of the fastest players on the wings, had to look like he had that ground ball all the way. Casey Powell out of nowhere, dives, makes a great defensive play.
Now Powell gets a screen as Jacobs peels off. Looking in front, loose on the floor. Now Oglesby's got it, shovels it ahead. Oglesby in the breakaway. Matt, he's in, shot, save. As he had him going left to right, but couldn't find the net.
Great save by O'Toole. Oglesby had the opportunity to pick the ground ball and did draw the penalty. So it is coming back to Philadelphia.
Well, after the play, Mike Hassan drilled Oglesby into the boards.
Great,
here he is.
Great ground ball, shows the speed of Matt Oglesby. Good little fake, almost had him. O'Toole went to his right side, came back with a tremendous off-hip save. Oglesby gives him a little fake there, O'Toole takes it. Matt goes for the net, O'Toole got there with the stick. Fantastic save by O'Toole.
That's a cross check as Oglesby was drilled to the boards following the shot. So Philadelphia, man advantage once more, down 10-7. And here they come, Finneran at the top. First time we've seen that. Berge slides, shot, saved O'Toole. Berge tries to scoop the rebound, cannot. Kept in by Finneran, crossing in front. And never able to get a shot away as the goal has moved well back off its line. O'Toole trying to reset the goal as Berge's trying to come up with the ball, lost a stick, and it's Rochester that comes out with it. Off the dasher boards. Again, they're down a man. And they'll bring it back for Mears. 1:20 and counting on the Knighthawk penalty to Mike Hassan. Powell around Finneran. Shot blocked, loose on the floor, and shot clock violation comes after Slate had come up with it. So Tommy will bring it back out. Philadelphia goes back to that offensive unit.
Making some changes on the extra man unit for Philadelphia. As we said, Finneran's at the shooting spot now. Marichek's not on the floor, he's in the box. So we go for a different look.
McAvoy down on the near side post. That went off a defender in front from the Berge shot.
Need to see the big shots up top from the top threats. Finneran, Berge, and Radabaugh. Need to keep the top guys honest, top defenders honest, so you can open up the lower shooters.
That rolls all the way back, over and back violation. Rochester ball with 32 seconds left, man advantage. 5:50 in period three. And with the 30-second clock recycled on the possession change, Rochester can just about rag through the rest of the Hassan penalty. But they want more than that. They've done very well shorthanded. Grant protecting against the double team, backs away.
Not a great matchup with Buzza on Grant because of his size and strength.
Good double team by Jacobs, but a push is called on Jacobs. And I believe he's heading for the penalty box.
I don't know where that's coming from. Jacobs made a great slide, gave him a little bit afterwards. Grant loses the ball and it goes out of his stick. Peter Jacobs seems to be a little miffed by that call as well. Here
right,
it is.
Wrap that around up the neck top. Early. But we've certainly seen a lot worse.
Absolutely. If you're caught up in the action like that, Jacobs did have a stick on Grant's stick and rake the ball out of his stick. Guess the refs didn't see it that way, and he's in the box for holding.
So the Knighthawk penalty will expire in 10 seconds. Then a 150 man advantage for Grant Jr. et al. From Rochester. Shot. That's a whiff. Long rebound comes to Slate. Slate's got a step. Shot off the inner post and behind O'Toole.
Great effort by Tom Slate. Here's Philadelphia now slowing it down a little bit, getting the right personnel on the floor. Tom Marichek's out of the box.
Delayed penalty coming against Rochester. So it's 6-on-5 at the moment. Marichek. Flip shot is handled by O'Toole. The net wide open as Dallas Elliott went to the bench. But we will apparently get a minor on a member of the Knighthawks with 1:21 remaining on the penalty to Jacobs. Day shows a little bit of concern and temper.
Not very happy with the call there. Legal substitution is it's a mental error, it's a bench error, something that a coach hates. It's the only time that a coach can really make a mistake. That time, Paul Day, and the Rochester Knighthawks got caught.
They'll call Bomberry, who came flying out the defensive door, if you will, for Rochester, trying to catch Slate from behind, thus the illegal substitution. So we're four aside on the floor with 4:51 remaining period three, 1:20 and counting on the Jacobs Minor to Philadelphia. Berge in traffic. Ryan, nice look in front, but that's broken free before a shot can be fired from Finneran.
Gotta want this ground ball, Philadelphia. Good effort. You need to have some more guys there. Don't let it go over the line. Great effort.
Philadelphia maintains possession. Mearns for Rochester gets his stick back. And Ryan brings it to the offensive area. Shot short hopper. Kicked out by O'Toole. And the loose ball belongs to Mearns. Thought about throwing the home run ball, looking for Malowski, but does not. Again, both teams down a man for the next 40 seconds. Then Philadelphia, 31-second man advantage. Rochester, a 10-7 lead, as you see. Methodically working in front, across, and the right elbow of Elliott comes up huge on Randy Krueger.
Great save by Dallas Elliott. Here's the two-man game for the Rochester Knighthawks now. They're doing their own pick and roll.
Score! Wow! Through traffic, Sudan.
Tim Sudan, this is a move that he's used for years. Sets a guy up to a strong right-hand side, takes an inside roll, puts the stick in his left hand, wraps it around, jams it in the net.
So Sudan has now moved ahead of Paul Gate on the Hawks' all-time points list. The legendary Paul Gate, as he gives his club an 11-7 lead.
Very tough guy, Tim Sudan, right there. Just put that goal in. Told you to watch him. He heard him.
Hey, Philadelphia Wings fans, why not experience all the bone-crunching, fast-paced Wings action with your friends, family, or the gang from work? Wings games are better in groups. Call 215-389-WINGS. And the two-time All-American who spent 4 years in Boston has really found a home in Rochester. Sudan gives Rochester an 11-7 lead. Back in a moment.
No matter where you look, the financial world is brimming with capital-generating tools for individuals and for companies. Yet in the entire world, there is but a single desire: to possess the most elusive commodity of all, an idea. For insight into your financial needs, come to the mountain called First Union Securities. Yet another way for the mountain to come to you.
To be a good shooter, you've got to use stick fakes. And the fake I usually use is a quarter turn fake, which you basically bring your stick from behind, you come all the way, your top wrist is turning a quarter of the way. Now your stick's in position for a shot on goal. You don't have to bring your stick back for the goalie to counteract where you're shooting.
Snyder's of Hanover has been baking pretzels for almost a century. Pretzels crafted from old world recipes and slow baked to perfection. With over 20 varieties, there's a favorite for everyone. Visit the Pretzel Bakery in the Snyder's section of your grocery store today.
Snyder's pretzels are munchably, crunchably, got a hunch they're gonna be
the finest bakery pretzels anywhere.
Snyder's of Hanover, America's pretzel bakery since 1909.
Remember, it's not too late to be a Wings season ticket holder this season. 3- and 4-game packages still available. Call 215-389-WINGS. Operators currently standing by. Rochester's built their largest lead of the game at 11-7. And a lot of it's been the specialty teams for Rochester.
Absolutely. When a team gets down on a man-down situation and the power play of a team like Rochester is on the floor a lot, look out, that's a very difficult way to defend your goal.
Sudan now has a 42 consecutive game point scoring streak. He's had himself a good half and a quarter. Buzza looking for a trailer, nothing develops. Maracek, Finneran's been quiet, held off the board with 3:30 remaining in period three, number 11 for Philadelphia. And there's Jake.
Need to see number 11 get in the scoring column. He needs a big goal here. He needs an assist. He needs something to get himself fired up.
Berge went through the screen and could not get that past O'Toole. Maracek shot over the top as he really wowed and fired. 15 seconds remaining on Philadelphia. Then Dallas Elliott comes out, and I think he's going to be called for a charge on Casey Zapp. Now Berge wants a piece. I mean, how far Dallas came off his line.
Well, Zapp was coming. He was going to get that ground ball, and he's going to be one-on-one with Dallas. Dallas doing the only thing he can do, lays him out. Zapp didn't see it, just saw it in time.
Yep.
Dallas breaks him in two right there.
Just the last step, right?
One of the things that was a new rule this year also was that the goalie is not allowed to come out of his crease that far. Therefore, it is a penalty on Dallas Elliott. He's going to go to the box for that hit.
Wow. With 2:59 remaining, Philadelphia would have still had a 9-second man advantage.
He's a guy that protects his crease like an angry dog. If you get near it or come down barreling down on it, he's going to protect it. And right there, he showed Casey Zapp a little bit of that.
And you got to make that decision right away, right? Either go or you don't go.
Absolutely. There's no second guessing. If you second guess, you're going to get a goal. So you got it. You're going or you're not. And he went and he laid him right out.
A huge discussion underway in front of the penalty box. But it looks like the members of the Wings are doing most of the talking and the Knighthawks doing most of the listening, which is not a good sign. As you see, one more look as Zapp gets his head up just in time. Whoa.
Bang. Normally the call is on this. Who's going to serve the penalty? Do they take Dallas Elliott out of the net, put him in the box, or can it be an actual runner that's in the box? That's what Tony Resch wants to know.
I'm talking.
Mike Ventura normally gets an earful from Tony Resch. He's trying to clarify the situation here. Paul Day wants to know what's going on as well so he can get the right people on the floor.
Looks like he will not serve, but it may indeed be a 5-minute penalty for the cross check. 2-minute cross check. And Dallas is headed for the penalty box. To a standing ovation at the First Union Center.
Tough play that Elliott has to come out and serve his own penalty, but I bet he's going to go to the bench. They'll put a runner in the box to let him serve it.
Andy Piazza with some words from John McAvoy.
Now, Andy Piazza, the pizza man right there, has been a backup for the Philadelphia Wings for years. He's been in the shadow of Dallas Elliott. That Andy Piazza can hold his own. He's a solid goaltender. He's an experienced veteran. He can get the job done. Unfortunately, it's situations like this that he has to come in off the bench. He's cold. He hasn't seen shots since warm-up, and now is expected to save the shots of one of the most powerful power plays or extra man shooters in the game in the Rochester Knighthawks.
That's a tough assignment.
And I'm telling you, I'm sure Rochester's going to come right at him. A couple passes, and they're going to be firing away.
You see Dallas in the box. Get those hammies going. Andy Piazza. Now, 8 seconds, it will be a man advantage for Rochester as they will take Bomberry out of the box in 2-1. He is out and will join the fray. Sets up in that shooting position, gets a touch. There's Grant. Threw it in front. Piazza goes down and makes the save and gets a handle.
Great tester for Andy Piazza. First shot, makes the save, gets himself some confidence. He's ready to see some more action.
Philadelphia will change as well. Now the penalty on the box upstairs indicates the five-minute major to Dallas Elliott has 4:20 remaining. Berge shot. And they kind of make sure that O'Toole has room to see that. Shot clock violation. Maracek knew it, but waited for the whistle.
Philadelphia needs to get some second opportunities, some second chances on the ball. It seems they're taking an errant shot, and then the ball's flying down the other end. They're only getting one attempt at it.
Philadelphia back in that box. And there is Grant. Grant tossed that toward the slot. It's loose. Loose ball picked up. Dangerous in front. And we've got a whistle. And a push foul called by Grant out high on McAvoy. Andy Piazza still trying to get those legs loose. That's all he did a year ago, was get into two games and made those 21 saves. He's had the honor of serving behind Dallas Elliott, I guess you could call it. Double team, Maracek down, whistle and a penalty.
He normally holds his own. It was the two-man game between Fair and Maracek.
Yep.
They got a cross check on Tom Maracek in the back. Some extracurriculars.
Pat Kogovan will go off.
Great bounce pass by Fair to Maracek. As Tom Maracek turns, John Grant Jr. gives him a cross check to the small of the back. He's headed to the box. Here it is. Tommy sets up. High check to the back of the neck, to his shoulders. He's headed off to the box himself.
Kogovan actually will serve that minor with 1:15 remaining. Period three, shot wide near side, long rebound, and Berge will try to chase it down to no avail, the over and back violation.
As I mentioned, the Wings are only getting one shot. They're getting one attempt at an offensive play, and then they're losing the ball. They need to get the second shots, the third shots, try to hit some pipe or hit the goaltender. When you have an errant shot like that, you're just giving it right back to Rochester. Tony's not too happy about it either.
3 minutes on the Dallas Elliott major, 1:35 on the Kogovan minor. So we're playing a man down on both sides. Screening and rolling, Mearns turns to the inside. All this by himself. Piazza holds his ground and dives across and covers as Grant takes a pop at Slate in front.
Great save by Andy Piazza. Right on top of him, makes a big save. Never know that he's a second stringer.
Maracek near wing. Flatten that out and find Fair, who opened the night scoring. He and Slate gave Philadelphia the early lead. Nice screen roll, shot score. Radaball, just the way you threw it up at halftime.
Exactly,
coach.
You couldn't highlight that anything better. There's our clip for the pick and roll. There's your basic pick and roll. That's the offensive fundamentals of the game. Pick and roll, here we go. Set by John Radabaugh, dumped by Tom Ryan. It's a goal. You couldn't draw it up any better. Little dump by Tom Ryan. John Radabaugh puts it home for the goal for Philadelphia.
His second of the season, and it's a huge one, really, to stem the tide in the final 20 seconds of the period. That's an even strength goal and makes an 11-8 Knighthawk lead.
Philadelphia's been down before. They were down pretty big last week against Pittsburgh. They're down against Rochester tonight. You exert a lot of effort by catching up, but they can do it. This game, you can score a lot of goals in a little bit of time, and they might be able to do it right here.
5 seconds left of the period. Piazza keeps that one away, and he's bouncing up and down at his net as the horn sounds. So a little bit of a momentum builder, courtesy of the backup goalkeeper, Andy Piazza. And a couple of guys not known for their extensive scoring work that got Philadelphia one of the proximity goals they need to take this one down the stretch. The Knighthawks take an 11-8 lead into period number four, and they will indeed have a power play as the period opens early in period number four. We'll come back and go down the stretch with period number four for you in just a moment.
Here's a big save by Andy Piazza to give him the momentum, to get him with his legs underneath him in the game, and then the perfect pick and roll by Ryan and Radabaugh.
Back in a moment.
We love the Wings!
Yeah! What better way to enjoy Philadelphia Wings lacrosse games than to go with your favorite friends to the First Union Center? The Wings offer a group sales discount for parties of 20 or more. Celebrate a special birthday that includes game tickets, visits from Mad Dog, and Wings party favors. Families love Wings games. A family of four pack that includes four tickets, four soft drinks, and four hot dogs is just $66. Call 215-389-WINGS for more package info and how to become a season ticket holder. Wings lacrosse, it's always a party.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Serious. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. Warburg.com.
Where can you get great tasting food and feel like you're in the heart of Little Italy? Eastside Mario's in Exton, of course. Eastside Mario's, where you're surrounded by the sights, sounds, and aroma of New York's Little Italy. Enjoy our famous warm garlic home loaf and all-you-can-eat super salad. Eastside Mario's is a great meeting place. Have a drink at the bar or bring the family in for some delicious pasta, chicken, seafood, herb crust pizza, and more. Stop into Eastside Mario's today, located on Route 30 in Exton, across from the Exton Square Mall. This is the service you get from your insurance agency if you're not with Miller's. Miller's Insurance Agency has a family of qualified insurance counselors available to you 24 hours a day. We're here before you go to work and still here after you're home. We're here Saturdays and after church on Sundays.
We're professional, we're dedicated, and we have the best insurance policies to meet your needs. And our claim services above all others.
Miller's Insurance Agency. Let our family help protect your family. Call us at 610-269-4500.
Major fourth period comeback. They're down by three, but here's the moment that supercharged this crowd.
Big hit by Dallas Elliott. Almost a breakaway. Dallas comes out of his goal. Lays out the defender. And then a huge save by his backup, Andy Piazza, coming in cold off the bench, makes a huge save. And he's ready for the fourth quarter.
And I guess if you got to know about Andy Piazza, you got to come to practice on Wednesday nights and see how he plays, because I haven't seen a ton of him in games the last few years.
Right, he's been there. He's seen a lot of rubber over his life. He's a fantastic goalie. He was an All-American out of the University of North Carolina. He's been a fantastic backup to the best goalie in the league for a number of years.
Thank you, sir. By the way, our crowd tonight at the First Union Center announced as 15,550. On this chilly late January eve, Philadelphia down three. They're still at even strength for the next 25 seconds. As Rochester tries to work in front, that's over the top of Piazza. And the loose ball handled by Powell. Brought back out to Mears. The shot clock reset, so they've got 25 seconds. The penalty will expire to Kogovon in 2-1, now man advantage Rochester for another minute 20. Kogovon heads for the bench. And they'll bring out Rusty Krueger in front. Piazza stands his ground, hugs that near post. And a fine interception behind by the long arms of Peter Jacobs. Pluck that one out of midair as they try to go across the crease. And Jacobs leads the rush.
Excellent defense by Philadelphia. You have to play with that a little bit more intensity when you have a different goal in there. Sometimes the Wings defense can let up because they know Dallas Elliott's in the background. But when you got Andy Piazza in there, Tony Rush is telling everybody to get a little more tight on defense to see what they can do to prevent the shots from coming.
Maracek 1-on-4 in the offensive area as they've already changed up to the defensive players on the backside. Just see if Maracek could create some magic. 27 seconds to the last major rush of this man advantage at the 13-20 mark for the Knighthawks. They have played solid fundamental lacrosse. Bombery lay it back out high. Jacobs wraps it around. Unnecessary shot. Rebound. Did that go through? The light is on.
No goal.
Piazza kept it away.
Great save by Piazza. Maybe this is the momentum breaker for the Philadelphia Wings. Big save by Piazza. Down in the offensive end for Philadelphia, that Berge and Maracek show are about to show you.
Berge sets the screen on two, but a third defender comes over to find Maracek. Breaks free, shot. Left foot save. O'Toole just stood his ground. And Maracek hammered behind the net by Hassan, who remained Philadelphia ball.
Great aggressive forechecking by Tom Maracek to get the ball back. He followed up his own shot, took the push. Philly gets it again.
Two-man game, far side. Maracek swinging, back to it, spinning. Comes top of the slot, gets a tower screen. Double team in front, shot, score! Berge picked that out of midair and buried it back in the net.
Like you said, the Berge and Maracek show just happened right there. Good work, pick and roll, pick and roll, pick, re-pick. It looks like Tom Maracek lost the ball, but it fell in Jake Berge's stick. He was at the right place at the right time. Tommy's trying to split the defense, does a little inside roll. It actually looks like he flipped it up in the air for Jake Berge, and he caught it. jammed it in. Tommy does the inside, clips it high. Jay catches the pass, beats O'Toole to the right pipe.
It's 11-9, and Dallas Elliott returns to the net. Andy Piazza with a great greeting from his mates for keeping the club in it. That could have been a disastrous 5 minutes. As he came in cold, it's 11-9. Howe can't accept that pass from Sudan. And now the loose balls are going more Philadelphia's way. Elliott with a good scoop up finds Oglesby. Middle of the floor, Oglesby has Mike Buzza. Buzza will pull it back out, set the half court. 12 minutes and counting, but it's just a two-goal game as Philadelphia's got the last couple. Finneran. Kevin has a Ryan screen, can't use it for much. Stays alive, gets free, score! First of the night, Kevin Finneran, and boy, did he use that screen.
Great timing for Kevin Finneran to show up here. They needed a big goal, they needed to get within one. Kevin Finneran's been quiet all night. Great two-man work by Tom Ryan. He occupies two defenders. Kevin Finneran comes off the pick, sets up left, right, switches back to his left, jams it in the net. Great goal from Finneran. Here's an angle from behind the net. Finneran coming around, spins left, gets it around, sees it, the left-hand pipe, jams it in there. Wings within one.
So a couple have gotten by O'Toole's stick side of late. It's 11-10, Finneran's third of the season. The veteran. Now with 119 goals as a member of the franchise. Second on the all-time points list, and that came at a great time.
Talked about momentum. This could be a momentum breaker right here. Wings are within one late, you know, with a lot of time left in the fourth quarter.
Possession for Rochester. Jacobs with the steal. Jacobs with the tie on his stick. Here he goes. Fires it high.
Great defense by Peter Jacobs. Excellent opportunity. Almost cashed in there.
And Powell is beaten by Elliott. Buzza goes down but maintains possession. Swipes it Powell. And a whistle as Buzza fighting hard with Casey Powell.
Great forecheck, checking by Casey Powell. All over there. Excellent defense by Peter Jacobs. Big check. Comes down one-on-one with the goalie. Takes a look. A couple big fakes. Just shoots it over the net of Pat O'Toole.
Clark hits the outside of the far pipe. As Clark almost had it tied. Shots are even at 40. Maracek in front. We're tied.
So quick, all over the floor. Fantastic play by Tom Maracek. 15,005 going crazy here in the First Union Center. It's a great thing to watch. It's set up Tommy Maracek, pick and roll. Jake Berge makes the pick. Tom Maracek one-on-one with the goal. It's normally a goal, and it is. He cashes in. Sets up, fake, five-hole, bang, goal, 11-11.
And where's the help?
No help. It's a fantastic pick by Jake. He occupies two men. Tommy comes in. Grant wasn't there for the slide. Maracek jams it home.
We're tied at the 11 on the fourth of the night from Tom Maracek. And Philadelphia's come all the way back to tie it at the 11.
You certainly can feel the intensity now of this place. This building is shaking. It's 11-11, fourth quarter. That's why the Philadelphia Wings games are so exciting. Tom Maracek, he does it all. He's getting big goals. Huge surge, huge run for Philadelphia to bring it back to tie it up. Paul Day's trying to get his team to regroup, but here's the guy that kills him. Tom Maracek, great move on the best defender on the Rochester Knighthawks. Beats O'Toole for a big goal, ties it in 11. Huge goal by Hollywood Maracek.
Philadelphia scored in the final 20 seconds of period three to cut it to 11-8. Then three unanswered goals, first 4.5 minutes, period four. So overall, four goals in the last 4:58 to tie it at 11-11. And showing a lot of heart.
Absolutely. It takes a lot to come back from the deficit. The Philadelphia Wings are showing the heart, showing the character.
And amongst those frantic Philadelphia Wings, Leif Elsmo. Leif.
Hey, guys, I went over to Paul Day for his little meeting with his folks, and he wants to get back to what makes things work for them. He wants more touches of the ball. He doesn't want a track meet. He wants them to slow down and move the ball like they do when they're effective for scoring.
Yeah, they've shown us some brilliant half-court sets with multiple touches and lovely goals.
They do show you their expertise with their ability to move the ball around. So Paul Day knows what they do well, and he wants them to concentrate on doing the things that they do well.
A lot of traffic in front. Try to break someone free. That's loose. No one knows it's on the floor. And a big hit by Towers and a shot clock violation. They'll let it play on. Slate has Oglesby. Slate off the bench shot. Score! For Jake Berge, his fourth goal tonight. He's got four assists. Another simple 8-point evening, and Philadelphia takes the lead at 12-11.
Wow, wow. Fantastic defense. Tom Slate picks up the ground ball, pushes it down. They've got a two-on-one opportunity. Jake Berge cuts from the bench, sees the upper left-hand corner, dives and sticks it in the net. Fantastic play. Tom Slate, he makes it happen. Sees Berge, fantastic control and individual effort by Jake Berge. Acrobatic, gets the pass, dives, pounds it in the upper right-hand corner.
Wow, that's wonderful patience by Slate and good vision off his off shoulder to wait for Jake to come out. Matt Oglesby stands there, hey, what about me?
Yep. Well,
the answer is we got a wing breaking off your left side. That's going to bury this baby.
You want to get it to the right guy in opportunities like that, and it's either Jake Berge or Tom Marichek that you want to get the ball into their stick. That's what happened just then.
Five unanswered goals for Philadelphia. Erasing an 11-7 deficit. They lead 12-11 as we approach the nine-minute mark. Shot into the midsection of O'Toole from Marichek. And back comes Rochester. Shot, score, we're tied just that fast. On a nice end-to-end run by that Tim Sudan, we're tied at 12.
No lead is safe in this game. Tim Sudan, he's a seasoned veteran. One of the leaders on the team comes down. Nobody's picking him up. Can't give him that much room. He sees the whole net, sees the upper left-hand corner, and puts it right there. Big overhand shot, probably looking for the pass. Coming right down the lane. Tim Sudan punches the upper left-hand corner.
Wow. The assistant captain with his third goal tonight. Rest talking to the referees.
Just like that, we're deadlocked at 12 again. Momentum is swinging back and forth.
Parted like the Red Sea, two on one. Fair. Went behind Oglesby. McAvoy the slide, back up without the ball. Now it's still on the floor. Loose one. Oglesby had it broken free. Bodies again fly. And Ryan has it. There's Ryan now. Shot. The splits, rebound over the shoulder. Fair. And that winds up back behind the net in row three. Fair went over the shoulder because the goalie O'Toole was down, so he had some room high side.
Big saves by Pat O'Toole right then.
Back comes Rochester. Tate cutting down the slot, then sets the screen. It's still alive for Jacobs. In front for Tate. Trailer knocked free and broken away. Terrific defensive work for Philadelphia. Finneran waiting. Line change complete in front, score! Finneran to Marichek, and Philadelphia takes the lead.
Defensive breakdown by Rochester. They didn't see Tom Marichek. That's not a guy you want to leave uncovered. Tommy comes down from the box again. He's on the right-hand side. He's wide open, comes down, couple fakes. He knows where to shoot on O'Toole now. Banks it five hole, beats him. Another look at it here. Tommy Wright on the right-hand side, pulls O'Toole high, then shoots it low.
Finneran also gave you the Magic Johnson no look away, too.
Yes, he did.
Turned the head.
Great assist by Kevin Finneran. Getting involved in the offensive action late in the game.
13-12 Philadelphia. And back will come Rochester. They'll not go away easily, that's for sure. Powell spinning, stopping, crossing. Back out Grant, over the shoulder shot is high and wide. Powell fights for it with Stilley. It's loose and picked up by McAvoy of Philadelphia. Both teams will change on the fly. Off the bench comes Maracek. High rebound off the end boards is controlled by Jacobs of Rochester. Sprinting up that near side. Looking to his bench for a cutter.
Nobody's picking up Jacobs.
Center that back in front. Looking for Mearns. Has to roll all the way back with a shot clock at 10. Bombray's shot, that's blocked by Jacobs way high up. With 6 minutes, 51 seconds remaining, Philadelphia's come all the way back to take a one-goal lead. It's 13-12 Wings. And don't forget, next Saturday, February 5th, is Drew Carey Night at the First Union Center. The Wings host the New York Saints. Great seats available at the box office or by calling 215-336-2000. Drew Carey Night here at the First Union Center. Resch has his club all around him. Day the same on the other bench. Down the stretch we come with Philadelphia, 13-12 lead over the Knighthawks of Rochester.
So, you thought nothing was bigger than the Big New Yorker pizza. Well, how about a chance to make your own CD? Free at CD Now. That's right. Order the Big New Yorker from Pizza Hut for only $9.99, and we'll give you your own personal access code. Go online to cdnow.com and choose 6 songs from a selection of over 75 artists and 200 hits. Personalize your own CD, then we'll mail it to you. Free. We make the pizza, you'll make the CD. Hey, I told you this was big. The Big New Yorker, another one of the best pizzas under one roof.
Now, what'll it be, sweetheart?
Let me guess. A nice, cold Pepsi. I wouldn't want to hear one of those crazy voices of yours, huh?
Honey, you ain't heard nothing yet. Hit it, fellas.
Make your next birthday party a huge hit. Come celebrate your birthday with the Philadelphia Wings by calling 215-389-WINGS. 13-12, and your big guns got to show up now.
No lead is safe. It's a back and forth game. Here's Jake Berge with a big goal, streaking from the sideline for a big goal right there. Then you got Tim Sudan coming right down the lane, jamming the net right past Dallas Elliott. And then just that quick, Tom Maracek left open in front of the net, bangs it, and there we are. Wings 13, Knighthawks 12.
Individually, Berge with 4 goals, 4 assists. Maracek a hat and 1 assist, has 4 points. Grant 2 goals, 3 assists to lead Rochester as Elliott very calmly scoops that bad boy with 6:38 remaining.
Great defense by Philadelphia. Nice pick and roll done by Rochester, but Philly was there to shut it down.
Jacob stops at the white line, waits for the change. Maracek behind Berge's screen, works down around Berge, gets to the front and scores. And scores. It's 14-12. Philadelphia has now outscored Rochester 7-1 in the last 9 minutes of play.
Rochester got caught in it. This is the pick and roll again. Jake Berge seals off 2 men. Tom Maracek comes around left to right, gets in front of the net, knows where to beat O'Toole, puts it down on a bounce shot right. Nobody's there to stop him. Bang, right there for the goal.
Hello, you.
Tommy, Hollywood Maracek puts the Wings up by 2.
That's his 12th of the season. And the numbers just keep building for him on the evening. It's 14-12. Philadelphia trailed in this game 11-7 with 20 seconds left in period number three. They're now up by a deuce with just over 6 minutes left in regulation. Whistle.
It's very hard in this game to control a lead that's as small as one or two. Philadelphia was up last week against Pittsburgh. They put a lot of effort into coming back from a deficit to go up and then have it taken away. So we'll see whether the Wings can control a lead right now.
Great eye contact between Berge and Maracek on that far side. Now Berge's going to play screener as Maracek rolls to the top. Oh, behind the back looking for Berge, who scoops it as he comes through the crease, comes out with it. Shot clock still at 9, so time for Radabaugh to line it up. Maracek over the shoulder with authority, fresh clock. Berge, ill-advised pass. Radabaugh, though, does get the ground ball and whips it toward the net with now 5:20 remaining. Ryan works over his man, Jeremy Hollenbeck, as they'll complete their change. A lot of traffic, Powell on the wing. And goes over the top, and it will be Philadelphia possession.
Excellent swarming defense by Philadelphia. John Grant had his blinders on. He was going to the hoop. Philadelphia swarmed on him, slid, made a couple of big checks.
Offensive unit, Clark on the near side. Clark sees a man in front, shot. Wrapped around over the top by Fair. On the nice look from Clark. Shot clock at 9 once more, Finneran. Gets a little baby screen, keeps it alive, goes down low. Gets the shot, rebound, score! And Fair just kept the feet moving. Has his second of the night, went to the front of the net, and Philadelphia by 3.
Being at the right place at the right time. Tom Fair's been in this game for a long time. He's a veteran. He takes the pick and roll set up by Finneran and Clark. Nice play. Finn goes down right and then takes it left. Fair's there, shovels the shot in for another goal. Finn coming down, has his angles shut off. The ball pops out in front. Tommy Fair's in there to bat it in.
Love those one-time bats in the back of the net. We're back live action, 4:20 remaining for Ferris' 5th. Second of the night, and here comes Rochester. Sudan crossing, bring it back out, shot, that's wide, well conceived. The Tate was wide. Good work by Towers to try to break that free. These big defenders have really paid dividends in the second half. Shot is wide. Rebound shot that is broken down off the back glass on the shot for Mearns. And Oglesby fights for it. Mearns comes out with it to Tate. Fresh shot clock just inside 20. Bombery off the bench has a cutter. Looking in front, wraparound by Powell is off his shoulder up high in the air. And that's going to be not a two-minute penalty, but a possession for Philadelphia as Oglesby was wrestled down.
Great effort by both teams. Nice offensive move by Rochester. Great defensive stand by Philadelphia.
Early on, when Rochester had the lead, you might not have been able to credit Jacobs and Stille and Towers and these wonderful large defenders, but in the second half of the contest in this fourth period, it's been all Philadelphia. Maybe that's part of the reason why.
Yep, they're getting it done. They're tightening up their defense very well right now.
That doesn't reach the net. Now Maracek, it's loose. Clark's got it behind. Clark triple team. Ryan's got it. Philadelphia's got two players all the way back in the defensive area with a 3-goal lead and 2:40 left. Now they'll fully change on the go. Berge back on with Finneran.
Using a lot of time here. Shot clock's down to 10. They'll get a new 30 right here.
Good scoop, Finn. That'll take us close to the 2-minute warning. And Berge and Finn broken free off Berge, but he's not going to let anybody get around him. And Finneran takes it back. And now the clock will reset again with 2:11 remaining. And it's awfully early to say it, I guess, but the Knighthawks just look out of gas. They have been hammered repeatedly, caught by Philadelphia, and passed. Finneran to the wing. The Maracek will dive it back out. Use that 15 seconds. McAvoy behind.
Winds are playing smart now. They're holding the ball. It wouldn't take too much air out of it. But they're shot. Having their opportunities.
Just with 1 second on the shot clock, McAvoy gets a shot away. Now 1:35, as you see. Philadelphia by 3. Ryan, a good stick check.
Great defense by Tom Ryan. Great ground ball by Tom Slade. Tom Fair almost in front.
Trailer over the top. On the shot by Hanford. Whistle and a timeout called by Rochester with 1:17 remaining. And the crowd rises up to salute the Philadelphia Wings, who are 77 ticks away from winning a nice comeback.
Big flurry by Philadelphia there at the end. Rochester, now that they have possession of the ball, they're regrouping. Philadelphia's talking about getting their best defensive players on the floor, look for some big bodies to be out there. Tony's getting the right guys out there, and Rochester's putting their right offensive players on the floor to see if they can score 3 goals in the last minute. Here's that pick and roll we saw. Berge occupies 2 men. Maracek comes down to the left side, jams it in there.
And you see Rochester fell behind 2-0. After that, they outscored Philadelphia by a count of 11-5. And since then, all Philadelphia 7-1 in the fourth period. And a lot of this after the hit by Dallas Elliott that he got the 5-minute charge for, man, that just inflated the entire building. And a reminder to stay tuned for Leslie Goodell and Pete Christie with Toyota Sports Night here on Comcast SportsNet immediately following our contest, which has 1:17 remaining. Philadelphia, a 15-12 lead.
Philadelphia Wings faithful around their feet in the last 1:17 of this game. Here are the defensive specialists for Philadelphia: Jacobs, Slate, Oglesby, Stilley, and McAvoy.
Rochester in a much must score situation. Leif Elsmo.
Watch for Sudan. They're looking for the defense to over rotate. Sudan would have been a prime target, but Philly's playing great defense.
Sudan was on the weak side at the post. Didn't come his way. 15-12 with 53 seconds remaining. Grant, nice dodge. Grant, the bounce is way out high. It's off that black net behind, and Philadelphia with possession. O'Toole will come off the bench. Lost a piece of equipment at the high slot. You see it in the middle of your screen. That's part of his shin pad, I believe.
Philadelphia looks like they're gonna kill it. Just let the clock run down.
We get a whistle and a stoppage with 26.1 to get that piece of equipment off, or to get it back to the goalkeepers. Philadelphia, a little early celebration.
With 26 seconds left, it may be safe to say that this is going to be a victory for the Philadelphia Wings. And if it holds up, this is a fantastic win at home for Philadelphia. Big momentum boost. They had a moral victory, so to speak, in the loss to Pittsburgh. They played very well. They're happy with the way they played. And to come out and beat a talented Rochester Knighthawk team the way that they have tonight is going to be a huge boost for Philadelphia to take it into to next week against New York.
Absolutely. Philadelphia's been a good fourth quarter club over the course of the franchise history, obviously. But this one that they won't much frequently forget, 7-1 in period 4. Oglesby with 10 on the shot clock, backs it off. Oglesby now with 5 on the shot clock. That'll be a no violation. Final 10 seconds. A hard-fought victory for the Wings of Philadelphia. Oglesby the intercept. 4, 3, 2, 1. It's over. The Philadelphia Wings score 8 of the final 9 goals in this contest. They come from 4 goals down In the final 30 seconds of period three, Berge and Marinchek with Elliott owned the fourth quarter, and they win it gone away by a final score of 15-12.
Incredible surge by Philadelphia to pull it out in the end. Great individual efforts by Tom Marinchek and Jake Berge. Dallas Elliott in the net. I mean, the big three there were there for him. Now they celebrate a great victory.
Philadelphia 2-1. We'll come back and wrap it up for you from the First Union Center in a moment.
Those Hawks are coming in fast.
Roger, squad leader. We've got them covered.
Lock on target and fire at will.
Tickets for the Philadelphia Wings' next home game are on sale now. The Wings take on their arch rivals from Long Island, the New York Saints. This Saturday night, 7:30 at the First Union Center. Tickets to all 2000 season home games are on sale at Ticketmaster or call 215-336-2000. Join the team. Get your tickets now. Because they're coming in hot.
Hey, get a load of the old timer.
That there is the legendary Radio Robert.
Who?
20 years ago, he was unstoppable. Had a slap shot you could hear but could not see, hence the nickname Radio.
Yeah, well, they can call him Rusty Robert now. Hey, Rusty!
Don't say it, Tony.
Still got that shot, Tin Man? Let's see it.
Punk.
Hey, maybe you should be a goalie, Tony. Tony?
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Serious. Then you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. Warburg.com.
I'm Leslie Goodell along with Pete Christie coming up on Toyota Sports Night.
Allen Iverson will be among the starters in the NBA All-Star Game. We'll see how Allen and his teammates fared against Detroit this afternoon.
The Flyers were looking to make it two wins in a row. We'll see if their luck could continue in Montreal.
And Hotlanta's been transformed into Coldlanta for tomorrow's Super Bowl. Derek Gunn takes a look at Titans' Eddie George as he gets ready for the biggest game of his life.
These stories and more coming your way on Toyota Sports Night. We'll see you at 10 o'clock.
Philadelphia Wings Lacrosse has been brought to you by Pico Energy, no doubt about it. By Pepsi, proud to be the official sponsor of the Philadelphia Wings. By Snyder's of Hanover, America's favorite pretzel bakery. By Penn Orthopedics, more doctors, more experience, more choices. By First Union, your guide to the financial world. And by Warrior, the means to dominate. Well, the strength and power of the Philadelphia Wings clearly dominated in that fourth quarter, wore out the Rochester Knighthawks, and they got it done on the offensive end, Scott.
Yes, they did. Great effort by Tom Marinchek here, taking a feed from Kevin Finneran. Then Marinchek again streaking down the side, low shot for another goal, and then they just kept it coming. Tom Fair with the big scoop off of Finneran missed, and the Wings just kept surging throughout the night.
There's your game summary. Marinchek with six goals on the night, including three in the fourth quarter. Berge, 8 points, 4 goals, 4 assists. And again, over the last period plus 20 seconds of period number three, 8-1 the advantage for Philadelphia. See the line score on the bottom. Philadelphia eventually ran away and hid by a final score of 15-12. And most of the best action for Philadelphia came following what became our First Union check of the game.
Fantastic surge in the fourth quarter, all sparked probably by this hit, bang. Dallas Elliott making the big hit, the First Union check of the game. That really led us to an 8-1 surge that closed out the Knighthawks.
Final score, Philadelphia 15. The Knighthawks of Rochester, their first loss of the season, with 12. Our reminder, we'll be coming right back at you on Comcast SportsNet against those Saints of New York next Saturday night at 7:30. Join Scott Gabrielson and I with Lee Velsmo next Saturday night at 7:30. Don Dorado and Bill Green led our production and technical effort. We invite you to stay tuned for Leslie Goodell and Pete Christie and all the night's action in the world of sports. Good night, everybody.
Coming up on Toyota Sports Night, the Flyers invade Canada. It was game two of the Twin Towers era, an afternoon delight. The Sixers can boast an all-star guard, but could they boast a victory in Motown? Derek Gunn reports from Atlanta as we count down to Super Bowl 34. Two members of the team of the 80s are on this year's Kids in the Hall. We'll also have all the local college hoops action you can handle. So keep your eye on the ball. Toyota Sports Night starts now.
Good evening, everyone. Live from the First Union Center, this is Toyota Sports Night. Alongside Leslie Goodell, I'm Pete Christie.
Coming up, the Sixers tried to motor past the Detroit Pistons. Some game called the Super Bowl is being played tomorrow. We'll update you on the weather problems in Coldlanta, and the NFL Hall of Fame selects five new